celebration.
There's never been a scene like this in this Coliseum.
Cut the net down in Auburn, Alabama.
Now that was basketball.
Auburn, SEC champs, and the celebration begins at Auburn Neville Arena.
After game day and the Outlive campaign, Auburn gets set for its annual battle with Kentucky. The Tigers put a 15-game home court winning streak on the line in front of the 53rd consecutive sellout at Neville Arena. Good afternoon, a War Eagle from Neville Arena with nine-time Hall of Fame coach Sonny Smith and Jacob Hillman. I'm Andy Bergeron. First place, South Carolina came to the Plains Wednesday night and left with a 40-point beatdown by the Tigers. Jalen Williams and Janai Broome combined for 9 three-pointers. Against the top defensive team in the SEC, Auburn scored 101 points and trails Alabama by a game for first place in the SEC. Kentucky features one of the best offenses in the SEC. The Wildcats are led by a quartet of guards, including Antonio Reeves. The senior from Chicago averages over 19 points per game, shooting 42% from the three-point line. True freshman Reed Shepherd comes off the bench to lead the Wildcats in assists. He's a son of a former Kentucky men's and women's player. The McDonald's All-American is shooting 52% from three. The Cats on the inside also feature not one, two, but 3 7-footers. Auburn's quest to win an SEC championship gets a big test today. The last time Kentucky won at Auburn was 2019. Get ready for a big battle on the plains. The CBNS Bank countdown to tip-off starts now.
Exclusive pregame coverage of the Tigers begins now with the CBNS Bank countdown to tip-off. Coming up, analysis, interviews, and a look around college basketball. At CBNS Bank, we've been family, community, and financially strong since we began in 1906. Visit cbsbank.com. Alongside Hall of Fame coach Sonny Smith, here's the voice of the Tigers, Andy Burcham.
You can tell this is a big game atmosphere here this afternoon as Auburn gets set to face Kentucky with nine-time Hall of Fame coach Sonny Smith and Jacob Hillman. I'm Andy Burcham. The last time Auburn beat Kentucky in Lexington, the Tigers, well, the man sitting to my right was the head coach. That was 1988. On the other hand, the last time Auburn beat Kentucky was 2 years ago here at Neville Arena. Boy, these games here especially have been terrific games with great atmospheres. I don't expect anything less today, Sonny.
Nothing less. When you play Kentucky, there's a different feeling in the game. You mentioned the word Kentucky. There's a different feeling. And no matter how good they're playing or how bad, Kentucky means something, and I want it to mean another loss.
That's exactly what Bruce Pearl's team is about to do today. This, of course, they are the gold standard in the Southeastern Conference. 49 SEC regular season championships. I mean, this is the team that you kind of circle on the calendar along with Alabama, along with Georgia, but certainly UK is on that, you circle that, yes, each and every year. And boy, this is a high-powered ball club that John Calipari brings in here this afternoon.
John is always going to have great teams, but I think this team might be a little more to his liking because he likes power, he likes to have a strong, he likes to have a good inside game and wants to run a lot, and I don't think he's got most of those things with this ball club.
Well, he certainly has a team that will run, and this is a guard-oriented ball club. Yes, there are 3 7-footers on his roster, but this team is run by the guards, Antonio Reeves, DJ Wagner, Justin Edwards, and the freshman Reed Shepherd.
Yeah, and you think about this. You get beat by the guards in this league. And if he catches up with the guards, he becomes another factor as far as winning a championship, like we are one of the factors.
Kentucky averages 88.9 points a game. On the other hand, Sonny, they're allowing over 78 points a ball game. If there is a deficiency with this Kentucky ball club, it has been its defense. Teams have been able to score. Kentucky scores, but teams have been able to score on UK.
Yeah. Well, if you run a lot, that means you're not getting up as many shots. You're playing more defense, and he's playing more, and maybe it's not as strong as it has been in the past.
Auburn has 3 losses in Southeastern Conference play, and in all 3 of those losses, Sonny, Auburn has given up 16 offensive rebounds. Boy, the Tigers, and this team is big, you've got to keep Kentucky off the offensive glass here today.
I think one of the big words with me is rebound with five. I think your perimeter people, when you play teams that are strong and good as Kentucky, your perimeter rebounders and shooters become the biggest factor in the game.
Auburn students started camping out for this game immediately after the end of Auburn's 40-point win against South Carolina on Wednesday night. They have been camping out for this game. Jungleville has been just packed all week long. Auburn is a healthy ball club today. Yeah. The Tigers are full strength as they get ready to face Kentucky. We don't know if Trey Mitchell will play today for the Kentucky Wildcats. He has been suffering from a shoulder. We'll see if he is in the starting lineup. He's playing today for UK in just a bit. Medical report today brought to you by East Alabama Health. Their team of first responders are proud to provide first aid care at every Auburn athletic event. This has been a busy day already in and around the Auburn campus, and Auburn softball ended up not playing today, in addition to a big day of Southeastern Conference basketball. And here to tell you all about it is our third member of today's crew, Jacob Hillman.
Thanks, Andy. You're exactly right. The SEC race continues to heat up, and that includes an upset of a top four team in the league. We'll tell you about some of the keynotes from today's game, so we take a look at the SEC scoreboard.
From the home of the five-time conference champions to every corner of the SEC, let's go around the most exciting conference in college basketball. This is the Toyota SEC Report. No matter your destination, Toyota goes with you. Toyota, let's go places.
Starting with this morning's games at 11 a.m. Central, number 15, Alabama hosted Texas A&M. The Crimson Tide got its 10th win in conference play to stay in first place in the league, 100-75. Mark Sears scored 23 points with 4 assists and 3 steals. The Aggies are one of the best rebounding teams in the country and the conference, winning that 47-37, including 26 offensive rebounds, but unable to get the job done. Tyrese Radford had 22 points, but the Crimson Tide able to limit Wade Taylor to only 10 points in that contest on 4-15 shooting. Alabama hosts Florida on Wednesday at home, and Arkansas goes to Texas A&M on Tuesday. Going to Athens, the Florida Gators defeated Georgia 88-82 to move to 8-4 in conference play. Obviously one of the hottest teams in the SEC right now. Auburn fell to the Gators last week in Gainesville. Florida had 5 in double figures, including 3 with 16 or more points. They trailed by 6 at the half, but were able to overcome that deficit. Only committing 8 turnovers, Florida took care of the ball. Georgia was led by Noah Thomason, who had 26 points and shot 50% from the field as a team. Going to Starkville, the Hump, Arkansas visited the Bulldogs and fell 71-67. 39 of its 67 points came from two players, Makai Mitchell and Khalif Battle. Mississippi State was led by Cam Matthews with 17 points and 10 rebounds. The Bulldogs moved to 17-8 overall and an even 500 in SEC play with 6 wins and 6 losses. Arkansas falls to 12-13 and 3-9 in SEC play. This game just went final in Columbia, South Carolina. The 11th-ranked Gamecocks fall again, this time to the LSU Tigers, 64-63. The Tigers got game-winning free throws with 5 seconds left from the Vanderbilt transfer, Jordan Wright, who scored 14 points and 7 rebounds. For the Gamecocks, B.J. Mack led the way with 18 points and 9 rebounds. LSU improves to 13-12 overall and 5-7 in the league. Number 11, South Carolina, falls to 21-5 and 9-4 in the league. That drops them in the standings as well, most importantly, as they were in the top four right there with Alabama, Auburn, and Tennessee. But now Tennessee will have a chance to tie them record-wise, but obviously South Carolina still holds that tiebreaker with the Gamecocks having to make a return trip to Knoxville. Later on tonight, and this one getting underway at the same time as Auburn and Kentucky here at Neville Arena, Vanderbilt will visit number 8 Tennessee. The Commodores are 7-17 overall with a 2-9 conference record, and the Volunteers, as I mentioned, looking to move to 9-3 in SEC play and try and maneuver its way into a top four spot in the league. As we look at those conference standings, let's go through that real quick. Alabama at 10-2, first place by itself. Auburn has a chance to move half a game back with a win tonight and be 10-3 in conference play. Tennessee's at 8-3 in conference play for third place. South Carolina at 9-4 after the loss to LSU. And then on the outside, looking in on that top four line, is Florida at 8-4, Kentucky at 7-4, and then there's several teams that can get to 6-6. Mississippi State's already there. Texas A&M's already there. And then Ole Miss tonight will look to get to 6-6 against winless Missouri. Missouri's 8-16 overall and 0-11 in conference play. The Rebels at the Pavilion, they have been stellar all year. Their loss has been to Auburn so far this year. So they'll look to get to 500 in conference play and join the Bulldogs and Aggies in the standings. But as Andy mentioned, it's also a busy day around Auburn Athletics. Auburn baseball gets a win. Auburn softball's game against Clemson gets canceled. But the Tigers do go undefeated in Mexico and will host the Plainsman Invite next weekend. Equestrian gets a weekend sweep with wins over Dartmouth as well as number 8 UT Martin. They'll be at home on March 2nd against number 3 SMU. Swimming and diving will be in action next week, Monday through Saturday, hosting the 2024 SEC Championships. Monday through Saturday inside the James E. Martin Aquatic Center. 11 a.m. start time, Monday and Tuesday, 9:30 a.m. the rest of the week. Number 12 Gymnastics will host its Senior Night and Breast Cancer Awareness Meet next Friday against number 14 Missouri at 6 Central. Wear pink and buy your tickets at aubtix.com. That's a good rundown of SEC scores, as well as a quick look around Auburn Athletics as we are getting set for number 13 Auburn and number 22 Kentucky at Neville Arena. And what's on the menu is presented by Whataburger. Give your taste buds that winning feeling with the new boneless Whata Wings from Whataburger. Crispy tender bites of chicken tossed in your choice of sauce, available for a limited time. Now what's on the menu tonight? A 60-second scout of Kentucky with Stephen Pearl and Sam Cunningham take center stage for a program profile. Plus, Andy Bergstrom's exclusive sit-down with Bruce Pearl, Coach Sonny Smith's keys to the game, your starting lineups, and eventually tip-off. All coming up when the CBNS countdown to tip-off continues in a moment.
CBNS Bank has a long history of stability and a legacy of serving our community's needs for generations. You could say we know a thing or two about tradition. We've been family, community, and financially strong since we began in 1906. Being a team player is part of our culture. That's why at CBNS Bank, we are proud supporters and huge fans of Auburn basketball. Whoa, Regal, hey! Visit cbsbank.com today. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Thinking of advancing your career with a master's degree in business? If so, consider the graduate degree choices at Auburn University's Herbert College of Business. Ranked among the nation's best, we offer full-time and online programs in finance, supply chain management, information systems, accounting, and business administration. Learn more at herbert.auburn.edu.
By now, your daily routine is probably a little too routine. Don't you want to change? Don't you want to start playing by your own rules and escape the routine so your fantasy becomes reality? Where every night is an adventure, where new flavors are ready to be tasted, where it feels like you're a winner. Take a chance. Reward yourself. Make your routine anything but routine. Escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
Who says you need snow to live in a winter wonderland? Southerners know a true winter smells like pine, cinnamon, and citrus. And the only warmth you need is delivered by time with friends and family. Farm fresh sweet potatoes, Christmas trees, and satsumas just make this time of the year even sweeter. Whether you're preparing to jingle some bells or settle into a silent night by a roaring fire, Sweet Grown Alabama has something for you. Find sweet potatoes, Christmas trees, satsumas, and more near you at sweetgrownalabama.org.
You're listening to Auburn Basketball. Now more of the CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off.
Jacob Hillman here with you courtside at Neville Arena to tell you that SeatGeek is now the official ticketing partner of Auburn Athletics. Whether you're buying or selling football, men's basketball, women's basketball, gymnastics, baseball tickets, softball tickets, SeatGeek is the place to do it. SeatGeek, so Tiger fans can fan. And I'll tell you what, this place is already just about packed out. There will not be a seat left open by the time we get to tip-off here at Neville Arena. Obviously, the jungle has been camped out in Jungle Village since Wednesday night. The first camper entered the, I guess, the barricades with his tent during the South Carolina game. He left that one with about 7 minutes to go, and he joined the line, I think, by the time the buzzer sounded on Auburn's beatdown of the Gamecocks. Well, the Kentucky Wildcats are coached by John Calipari, who is in his 15th year in Lexington and has led the Wildcats to 4 Final Fours and a national championship. Kentucky is trying to win back-to-back games for the first time since it defeated Georgia and Mississippi State on January 17th and 20th. Senior guard Antonio Reeves is an anomaly on this Wildcat roster as a fifth year who has played 2 years in Lexington. He leads the team with 19.4 points per game. 4 others average double-digit points, including a trio of freshman guards in Rob Dillingham, Reed Shepard, and DJ Wagner. Stephen Pearl gives us his 60-second scout of Kentucky.
How about a scout on Kentucky?
You know, one of the best offensive teams in the country, and especially in transition. They play at one of the fastest tempos in all of America. They shoot the three as well as anyone in the country. I think they're third in the country in three-point field goal percentage, and they have 3 guys that shoot over 46 or 47%. So they have 3 guys that are, you know, just unbelievable dead-eye shooters. So in transition, we got to get back and build a wall and try and get them into their half-court sets while locating their guards and their shooters. You know, their guards account for, you know, 65, 70% of their scoring night in and night out. So we're going to have our hands full on the defensive end. And then offensively, the biggest thing that we have to do is we can't turn the ball over. No live ball turnovers, because that turns into transition. And they're one of the best shot blocking teams in the country. I think they're number 2 in the country in block shots. So we can't go in there and throw up bad shots, because they'll block shots and then they'll get out and into transition. So offensively and defensively, transition is going to be a big key.
It's an interesting mix of really good shooting guards, and yet they've got size on the inside defensively to complement that.
Yeah, I mean, their young guards are all just prolific shooters. But, you know, I think we do have an advantage on the inside because they are a little bit thin up front. And I think our bigs can take advantage of their guys down low. We just got to be smart about it. We got to use shot fakes. We got to create angles, create duck-ins, try and get easy opportunities. And then our fours and fives have to do a great job of crashing the offensive glass. We can't send multiple guys to the offensive glass in this game because they're so dangerous in transition. But I think our 3, 4, and 5 can use their size and their strength as an advantage.
Does this team's style, especially offensively, remind you of anyone else that Auburn has faced this season?
I mean, Alabama would be the closest comparison just because they both play at such a fast tempo, and, you know, they really do get it up the floor and go, and they have similar guards as far as their ability to shoot the three. So that would probably draw the best comparison. They have longer, more athletic bigs than Alabama does. So they're not going to play as much small ball as Alabama did, so there will always be big guys on the floor. So that would be the main difference, but Alabama is probably the biggest comparison that I could draw to.
Trey Mitchell is the fourth leading scorer and top rebounder on this Wildcat roster. It's questionable coming into today's game, and he is not dressed out, so it does not appear that he will play today. So no Trey Mitchell for the Wildcats today. And the 60-second scout is presented by the Raymond J. Harbert College of Business, home to 7 top 25 programs in the U.S. News & World Report rankings. Harbert, inspiring business. Sam Cunningham's journey to Auburn as a team manager is closely connected to Outlive and Coach Pearl. On March 7, 2017, Sam was diagnosed with pre-B acute lymphoblastic leukemia while in the 6th grade. 2 weeks later, he would come down with a fever and spend the next 83 days in the hospital. During that time, Coach Pearl sent him a video encouraging him as his journey began. The two stay connected through the years, including Cunningham speaking to the team after a relapse in 2020 prior to that season's Outlive game. Not only is it the first Outlive game he will attend as one of the team managers, but it will also be the first Outlive game he'll attend since he was declared cancer-free on March 16, 2022. Andy Burcham sits down with Sam Cunningham for today's program profile.
Sam, Coach Pearl calls you the rebounder. Why does he call you the rebounder?
I'm always here rebounding for the guys, and I guess that's where he always sees me all the time.
Give us an update on your health.
I'm doing great. I've been a year post with no cancer cells in me, and then I just go to monthly checkup visits.
Where did your journey take you, literally, geographically, with your cancer treatment?
Well, my first go-around with cancer, I met Bruce, and then he told me he would save me a spot as a manager, and then I had to get into Auburn. And then Bruce kept up with his word, and now I'm here working with him.
What about your cancer treatments? Where were you all with regard to your cancer treatments?
When he told me about that, I was in the – when he told me he would save me a spot on the team, I was in the midst of my first cancer journey. I feel like in the middle of it, right in all the rough of everything. And then He gave me his phone number, and he kept up with me ever since. And I came to all the Outlive games I could come to each year, and then I just kept texting with him, and then I finally made it here, and then he still got me a spot.
There's a famous picture of Coach at the 2022 Outlive game, and the picture of him with holding up the placard, and Dick Vitale's name is on there, but the top of that list is Sam Cunningham.
Yeah, I was very shocked. I was actually in the hospital room watching that game, and then I was watching it, and my phone just started blowing up. Everybody's sending me pictures of that, and then I looked at my name was on top, and I saw Dick Vitale was below it. I was like, oh my gosh, can't believe he put me above Dick Vitale. And then later that night, he called me right after the game. I said, I like seeing my name up there. He said, you think I'd put you below Dick Vitale? He said, you're my number one, Sam. I want to put you below Dick Vitale.
What does it mean for you now that this journey has brought you now to Auburn in that spot that he saved for you? He tells us you're a good student as well. So what does it mean for you now?
I'm just truly grateful Bruce is the great person he is today. But keeping up with his word and keeping up with me through my cancer journey, and then some people, they'll reach out to you and then won't reach out to you again. But Bruce has been real special in keeping his word and keeping up with me too.
Right. Last question. You have been through this now, a very arduous journey, physically, I'm sure, emotionally, spiritually. What is your message for those that are perhaps going through it right now?
I'd say that those people going through a cancer journey, you're going to have hard and tough days, but you need to look past and through that, because I have a thing. When I was in the hospital, I noticed people who had a bad attitude about it, they ended up not doing great. But if you had a good attitude and were positive about it, you came out doing better, and that's what I believe in. But having faith with God and praying, and then just keeping your head up and through all those tough battles and stuff, and just know that you'll get through it.
Glad to have you here, War Eagle.
War Eagle.
Good life.
Well, Sam's story is certainly an inspiring and incredible one. And as it continues, he spends the early and late hours inside Neville Arena helping his teammates improve their game. Just because the weather's chilly doesn't mean Alabama farmers aren't busy growing high-quality products. Visit sweetgrownalabama.org to make your next Tigers watch party a slam dunk. Find farm-fresh greens, meats, and more at sweetgrownalabama.org. Well, both teams have taken the floor for pregame warm-up. Sam Cunningham down on the baseline, rebounding for the Auburn Tigers. They get set. The crowd continues to file in, and as I said, I don't think there will be a seat open when we get to tip-off between number 13 Auburn and number 22 Kentucky. It's the Outlive game for the Tiger. Everyone in their Navy or Outlive shirts. There will be a pregame ceremony discussing Outlive, the donations made, and everyone in the crowd will hold up their placards to honor someone that is fighting cancer. So up next, Andy Burson's exclusive sit-down with head coach Bruce Pearl ahead of Auburn and Kentucky at a jam-packed and juiced-up Neville Arena. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
My joints aren't what they used to be. Routine exercise, playing ball outside with the kids, riding bikes on vacation. I never worried about keeping up. But now, my joint pain has started slowing me down. I decided to make an appointment with the orthopedic clinic. Their surgical partners had the experience, technology, and personalized approach to care that I was looking for. Best of all, it was close to home. I'm thankful I chose the orthopedic clinic. Don't let joint pain slow you down. Visit theorthoclinic.com and schedule your appointment today.
At Jewelry by Design, we design and hand make officially licensed Auburn University jewelry. We are fully stocked with the largest selection in town. Come by Jewelry by Design and see all of our fabulous designs. And just for looking, receive a free $60 Auburn charm. Just say, I heard you on the radio. Jewelry by Design, proudly making Auburn in Auburn. Find us at jbdauburn.com or 590 North Dean Road in Auburn.
More on your balances with the Max Elevate Money Market. Enjoy the competitive rate benefits of certificate accounts with no fixed terms and more flexibility. Earn more on your balances and access them anytime. You expect more and Max delivers. See our amazing rates at mymax.com/elevate. Max, smart money made simple. Federally insured by NCUA. Certain restrictions apply.
Need great gifts for your family, friends, clients, and colleagues? You have to try Buff City Soap. Their soap, oils, body butters, bath bombs, candles, wax melts, and laundry soaps are delightful.
Pick from a variety of handmade goodies with plant-based ingredients that delight your skin and smell wonderful. See partywithbuff.com to schedule your party or visit buffcitysoap.com to check out their many alternatives. Try the free short-term parking at the 320 West Magnolia Avenue building in downtown Auburn and fall in love with Buff City Soap.
Ford presents our exclusive pregame visit with head coach Bruce Pearl. Great things are possible when you have the power, performance, and smart features of a Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. Greatness starts at your local Ford dealer. Here's Andy Burcham with Coach Pearl.
It has been a big day in town for you, and good to be on game day to have those folks in town. But now time to focus on the reason we're all here today.
Yep, it's a great atmosphere having college game day back in Auburn. It's great for the city of Auburn. It's great for the university. It's great for our sports programs and to have a national, actually a worldwide television audience here for college game day. And, you know, you work all year long, Andy, to put yourself in position to be in a play in games like this.
Kentucky in town today. Boy, you take a look at this offense, and boy, it's as good as you're going to see maybe the rest of this year inside or outside the Southeastern Conference.
Absolutely, yeah. They're one of the best offenses in the country. They got four guards that are probably going to be going to the NBA next year. Maybe two, or maybe one or two come back, but, I mean, that's how highly ranked these guards are. And, you know, their guards are five of their top six guys are scoring guards are guards, and that's been something that we've struggled with a little bit. If you think about Mississippi State's guards, Alabama's guards, or Florida's guards, so we got to do a good job of guarding our yard and making them settle for tough twos, and we got to run them off that 3-point line because this is the best 3-point shooting team in the conference.
What is the key to that? Getting out and getting them off the 3-point line.
Well, key is getting back in transition because they shoot so well in transition and finding shooters, not turn the ball over offensively, because if you turn over offensively, then they're going to come down and they're elite in transition. You got to really work on sprinting back and, you know, getting matched up. Offensive rebounding on the inside out threes, I think, is important. And, you know, not coming off shooters as they drive, draw, and dish, and those guys, they're long too. So if that ball gets kicked out to Reeves, or it gets cut out to, you know, Wagner, and Shepard's 6'3", he's not 6'1", and, you know, they get it off quick and they shoot it from great range, and so that's something we got to take away from them.
And not just shoot it at range and shoot it quickly, but they shoot it, they're accurate. This is a good at shooting basketball.
Yeah, it's the best three-point shooting team that John Calipari's had, in my opinion, just because of the depth and breadth of the amount of shooters. He's letting these guys play with great, great freedom. They shoot it earlier in the clock than they ever have, and as a result of shooting it early in the clock, they don't turn it over much. And so part of our success has been teams that kind of wanted to run some offense, and we could game plan a little bit, scheme, and take away some things and bother them a little bit. It's hard to turn Kentucky over.
One of the first things you told the team at film study today to challenge them was, look at the three losses in the league. Mm-hmm. One of the things that has been common in all three, you guys have given up offensive rebounds. What's the key for that here today?
Well, we just got a guard's got to rebound down. Big's got to increase their umbrella because they're really, really long. You know, just understand that if they, you know, just don't want to give them easy ones. So I think the physicality is important, and we play with great physicality. You know, again, try not to let the guards beat us as best we can. Rotating over, giving a little bit more help than we typically do as they line us up, drive us 101. And then again, just taking care of the basketball. I thought that's going to be a real key, because if you turn the ball over, they come down and they score.
Have we made too much of the rivalry between you and John Calipari in your careers?
Well, I mean, we've been doing it for a long time. You know, he and I both been doing it for a long time. We've gone up against each other when I was at Tennessee, and he was at Memphis, and obviously now that he's at Kentucky and I'm here at Auburn, and you know, so it's a good rivalry because both teams have been really, really good. You know, I don't want to beat Kentucky because of John Calipari. I want to beat Kentucky because they're still the gold standard in our league. In this game, it matters nationally. Perception matters, and matters in recruiting. And obviously the stakes are really high because, like, we're a half a game out of first, or maybe now I think we're one game out now that Alabama has won. And we're, like, maybe one and a half games out of sixth.
a, a message for you to the students that were camping out for this game as soon as that game ended Wednesday night?
Well, one of my gifts, and this is a gift from Brandy and myself, is we paid for, and we're blessed to be able to pay for the all those Outlive T-shirts that the students aren't going to get. And so those kids that did camp out, they're going to be able to be first come, first serve right there on the floor and wear that Outlive T-shirt with great pride. And the more they wear it, the more we get a billboard out there reminding people that the best way they can outlive their cancer is to detect it early. So before the game today, we're doing the PSA screenings for prostate cancer. And I'm going to get mine, and I'm sure you're going to get yours. And I think that's what's most important, and hopefully everybody will buy their shirts, and everybody will get in a, what is it called, that Q code, or the QR code, or go to outlive.com right now and make a contribution so that we can help patients in the state of Alabama meet the financial need of battling their cancer.
All the best today. War Eagle.
War Eagle.
Hey, it's Bruce Pearl. When you find a player who's electric, what a game changer. Like the all-electric Ford F-150 Lightning truck. It's got the performance you'd expect from an F-150, plus state-of-the-art tech like intelligent backup power. So if the lights go out at your properly equipped house, you've got the power to turn them back on. Game changing. That's what I'm talking about. See your local Ford dealer to learn more about the F-150 Lightning. Available at Ford EV certified dealers only. Some models, trims, and features may not be available and may be subject to change.
Yellowwood knows that a five-star backyard is the place to make lasting memories. Like roasting marshmallows on a cool fall night. That's it. Turn it nice and slow. Get it toasted all... Oh, no, it's on fire. Oh, you want it on fire. Okay, that's a choice, I guess. Crunchy. For five-star backyards and the most memorable experiences, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
War Eagle, it's a great day for Auburn Tigers to get vaccinated. Many children and adults that delayed vaccinations during the pandemic are still behind schedule. It's crucial that we take steps to get everyone back on track with their routine immunizations. Children and teens can still catch up on their vaccinations even if they start late. Make sure you and your family are all up to date on all recommended vaccines, including COVID-19 and flu. Let's all do our part to get back on track. Don't wait. Vaccinate. For more information, visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM.
Kia of Auburn is happy to connect the Kia brand to the Auburn fans. Our winning lineup has something for everyone at almost any budget. SUVs like the Telluride, Sorento, and Sportage. You prefer a sedan? Check out the Rio, Forte, Soul, or the Sporty Stinger. And don't forget our new multi-purpose vehicles, the Carnival, or our amazing hybrid or electric vehicles. Kia of Auburn is a proud supporter of Auburn Athletics. Kia of Auburn, where you're always number one. Whoa, Rico.
You're listening to Auburn Basketball. Now more of the CBNS Bank Countdown to Tip-Off.
Welcome back to Neville Arena, where we're getting set for number 13 Auburn and number 22 Kentucky. Jacob Hillman here with you courtside at Neville Arena to remind you, and did you know that the same people who installed the sound system at Neville Arena are also available for your next special event? Auburn AV can handle any size event. Visit auburnav.com to see all their audio video solutions. And before we continue, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the Auburn Sports Network. All right, as both teams take the floor for their final pregame warmups, we bring in the Hall of Fame coach Sonny Smith for his keys to the game presented by Kia of Auburn. Coach, this crowd has filed in early, and they've been camped out for days. I think this crowd's already into it. How does the Tigers keep them in the game early on?
I think they got to do what they've been doing. Every time they play somebody, it's been basically the same. They've dominated the games a lot, sometimes in certain areas, but do everything you've been doing and do it well.
You're coming off a 40-point win over the number 11 ranked team in the country. So how do you continue that momentum into a game that's even more amped up?
Well, first thing, stay out of foul trouble. When you play Kentucky, that's the first thing, I think. Stay out of foul trouble. And second thing, they're going to be very physical. So take care of the basketball and get shots. That's the number one thing. Don't have them turning you over on physical play.
We talked about Kentucky's offense and how high octane it is. It can score up to 100 points, just like Auburn's offense, but defensively for the Tigers. What is the key to slowing down those guards and those scorers for the Wildcats?
Well, once they beat you on the dribble, get help from the inside, and that's number one. Don't let them take it to the basket without help. And the other thing is, only give this bunch one shot. Their shooting percentages are not any better than the teams they're playing, but second shots, they can hurt you real bad. And also blocking shots, they can do that.
Kentucky will be without its leading rebounder today. That sounds like a recipe for Jani Broom and Jalen Williams to have a good game. How are they going to be able to get in the paint and dominate like they have been?
Well, they're a lot like Auburn. You can lose one guy and you can still play and play well. And I think Auburn will look at it. I don't think they'll look at Mitchell being gone or whoever. I think they'll go out and attack him as if he were here, and I think they'll play just as well or even better. And I expect this to be a normal, if normal is a word, Auburn-Kentucky game. They've always been lights out, sellouts, everything like that, and I expect this to be the same way.
All right. Coach's keys to the game. We appreciate that, Coach Sonny Smith. Coach's keys to the games are presented by Kia of Auburn, where you're always number one, straight ahead. We have starting lineups and tip-off of Auburn and Kentucky from Neville Arena. We take one more break for the 13th-ranked Tigers and 22nd-ranked Wildcats do battle. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
When you see the SEC student athlete, it's easy to picture the swing, the stance, the form. But look closer, and you'll see the heart, the brain, the clutch lab partner, the avid two-stepper, the pride of a hometown, and a little brother's hero. More than students, more than athletes. In the SEC, it just means more.
Here's a clip from a recent Talking Tigers podcast with Andy Burcham. Hal Baird.
I met Janie when she was 14 and a half years old as a freshman in high school. Man, oh man, she was the prettiest thing you ever saw. We started dating then, and we still haven't stopped dating yet. I guess we dated for 7 years before we got married. Now we've been married, I'm going on 52. And doesn't give a rip about baseball or football or anything else. She just wants the people she liked to do well and be happy. She asked me last night if a foul ball was a strike. Now, this is after going to baseball games for 55 years, and we're watching the Phillies play the Diamondbacks, and she wants to know if a foul ball is a strike.
How did you respond to that?
Oh, I said, oh, my gosh. She is, what you see is what you get. She has no pretense. Just a wonderful person.
A new episode of the Talking Tigers podcast is released every Monday. Wherever you listen to podcasts, like and subscribe to the Talking Tigers podcast, only from the Auburn Sports Network.
CBNS Bank has a long history of stability and a legacy of serving our community's needs for generations. You could say we know a thing or two about tradition. We've been family, community, and financially strong since we began in 1906. Being a team player is part of our culture. That's why at CBNS Bank, we are proud supporters and huge fans of Auburn basketball. Whoa, Regal, hey! Visit cbsbank.com today. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
This is Auburn basketball, and these are the Yellowwood starting lineups. Brought to you by Great Southern Wood, makers of Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it. Now, the starting five for the Tigers.
Trey drives to the basket, through the lane, hang, shoots, goes past Donaldson, 4-3. Count it!
Everybody's joining the fun.
Steal, Donaldson, he's got a breakaway. To the hole, he jams it, and Auburn goes up one.
Trey Donaldson, Tallahassee, Florida, Florida State University School.
Three ball Denver. Made three Denver.
Take that.
Off the left side, Denver Jones three. Yes!
All right.
18-footer Denver swish.
He's got a good look about him right now, Andy. I've got a feeling that Denver Jones is going to go off.
Denver Jones, Newmark, Alabama, Buckhorn High School.
Whip around pass and it comes to Moore who drives the ball and jams it. Auburn breaks the press quickly. Jones underneath. Moore banks it in on the alley-oop. Taylor gets the rebound. Outlet Hayden ahead. Chris Moore. One dribble. Double end zone.
Chris Moore, West Memphis, Arkansas. Academies of West Memphis.
Auburn Auburn the other way. Jalen to the hole. Yes!
Great lead
and
pass
a foul.
Ahead
for Jalen. Splits defenders to the hole. Got it! And he's tied his career high.
Ahead Holloway. Lobs it.
No! Jalen with a double hand dunkaroo.
Jalen Williams, Manhunter, Georgia, Brantley County High School.
Out to the top for Janai. He'll pop a three. His third of the night, that all sets right. A career high. Underneath Broom, two-handed hammer.
It's called a pick and roll.
Lobs it ahead. Broom to the hole with the left hand. Yes, and a foul!
Janai Broom, Plant City, Florida, Tampa Catholic.
God bless America, the outlived
and now,
folks as well. And we're about ready for basketball at Neville Arena. Auburn is 20-5 on the season, 9-3 in Southeastern Conference play. The Tigers are ranked 13th in the AP poll, 12th in the coaches poll, number 5 in the NCAA net, number 4 in the KenPom poll. Bruce Pearl out of Boston College is in his 10th season at Auburn. A record of 193-116 in his 29th season overall. A record of 655-261. Kentucky is 17-7 overall and a 7-4 in the SEC. Ranked number 22 in the AP poll and the 20th in the coaches poll. Number 24 in the NCAA net and 26th in the KenPom poll. John Calipari out of Clarion is in his 15th season in Lexington, a record of 404-120. 32nd season overall, a record of 849-260. Here's the starting lineup for Kentucky. DJ Wagner at the point, 6'4 freshman from Camden, New Jersey, a McDonald's All-American, 192 pounds, 11.2 points, 1.7 rebounds, 3.6 assists. Antonio Weaves on one wing, a 6'6 senior out of Chicago, transferred to Kentucky from Illinois State. Leads UK at 19.4 points a game with 4.3 rebounds. Justin Edwards, a 6'8 freshman on the other wing from Philadelphia and Hemotep Institute Charter. 8.3 points, 3.6 rebounds for the left-hander. Adu Fierro gets the start at the four, a 6'8 sophomore from Pittsburgh. Quaker Valley High School missed 7 games with an injury earlier this season, averaging 7 points, 5 rebounds a game. He is in the lineup for the injured Trey Mitchell. And Ugana Onosu, a 7-foot sophomore from Owerri Imo State in Nigeria. 4.1 points, 4.8 rebounds, and 3.2 blocks per game. Reeves, Wagner, Edwards, Fierro, and Onosu for Kentucky. Our officials today, Steven Anderson, Joe Lindsay, Vladimir Boyard Tadal. 20-5 Auburn, 17-7 Kentucky. Sonny Smith, both of these teams. This is an incredibly important game for both of these squads, as it is year in and year out.
Well, anytime you play Kentucky, it's one of the biggest games. The fans think that. Your players think that, and coaches think that, and I believe that's the way it is with everybody.
Auburn students began lining up for this game before the Wednesday game ended against South Carolina. They have been intense ever since,
outside. I hope they had online courses for their classes Thursday and Friday, but nonetheless, they are here en masse. As most everybody here that is in orange and blue is in the blue outlet T-shirts here today. All right, give me a couple keys early on for this one, Sonny.
Get back on defense and stay out of foul trouble on the perimeter. Rebound on the perimeter, guys, have got a rebound for us.
No question that rebounding is vitally important in this game. As mentioned earlier, in Auburn's three SEC losses, they have given up an average of 16 offensive rebounds a game in the loss at Alabama, in the loss at Mississippi State, and in the loss at Florida, and that was just 1 week ago.
I tell you, we're a good rebounding team, and if all five of our three guys and all five of the guys block out and we throw this into a not a total half-court game, we're going to win this game.
This will be one of the biggest teams that Auburn faces in the SEC. Reeves is 6'6", Wagner is 6'4", Edwards is 6'8", Fierro is 6'8", and Onyesu is 7 foot. Now, as big as Kentucky is, Auburn feels that it can get inside on UK because they feel that Auburn's stronger on the inside.
Stronger and possibly quicker. And if we can do that, I think it's going to be one of the factors in the game. But I really think our perimeter guys must stay out of foul trouble and get inside of their defense on the dribble.
And boy, you better get back on defense because this UK team wants to run. They want to run Auburn into the ground, and we haven't seen that very often this year.
And we're not going to see it today because we've been pretty good at getting back on defense. I think we'll do that again.
Auburn in the home white uniforms, tops and bottoms, with the blue numerals and lettering and the orange trim, the AU on the trousers. Kentucky in the Kentucky blue tops and bottoms, white numerals and lettering. And we're about ready for basketball. Finally, goodness gracious, finally ready for basketball here at Neville Arena this afternoon between the Auburn Tigers, your Auburn Tigers, and the Kentucky Wildcats. Donaldson, Jones, Moore, Williams, Broom for Auburn, Reeves, Wagner, Edwards, Thiero, and Onyesu for Kentucky. Joe Lindsay into the center circle. Broom against Onyesu. White shakers all around the building. The tap is controlled by Auburn. Chris Moore won that one. Tigers to the basket, to our left, we're underway.
Kentucky playing man for man, a strong man for man.
An aggressive man for man. Off the left side, Donaldson. Screen from Broom. Right wing for Chris Moore. Back out to the top for Donaldson. 14 to shoot. Trey near the sideline. Another screen from Broom. Free throw line. Trey picks it up, throws it away. Tried to get it underneath to Broom. Auburn says it was deflected out of bounds by Kentucky. Nonetheless, the Cats get it.
We will press. It's more of a press to slow them down. Sometimes we can get a steal out of it.
Edwards in the backcourt. Gets the ball to Fierro. Now to Wagner across midcourt. Wagner off the left side for Fierro. To the right wing for Edwards. Top of the circle. One, Wagner wide open. Three, didn't get it. Rebound tapped out and saved by Kentucky. Fierro out at the top. Working on Jalen Williams to the free throw line. Down the left side. Back out to the top for Wagner. Shot clock at 11 for UK. Wagner double teamed. He's in a little trouble. Throws it to the baseline and a dunk by Justin Edwards.
We tried to trap at midcourt and lost our man in another basket. But we're playing man for man and we'll not do that again.
2-0 UK. Auburn ball, 18:55 in the first half. Donaldson, a scream from Broom inside the arc. Picks it up. Left wing, Chris Moore. Three! In and out. And the rebound to Onyesu for Kentucky. Up the floor, UK. Fierro, right wing, wide open. Reeves for three. Didn't get it. Rebounded for Donaldson for Auburn.
Kentucky's going to run. We will run. It'll be a running game.
Donaldson across midcourt. Tigers trail 2-0. 18 and a half minutes to go in the first. High post screen by Williams. Donaldson to Jalen between the circles. Left wing, Denver Jones. Down to the low post, Broom against Onyesu. Backs his man in, gets double teamed. Spins to the basket, banks it in.
If they let him turn to his right shoulder, he is a dangerous player, and I like the way it happened right off.
2-2 the score. Wagner between the rings, picked up by Denver Jones. Wagner now between the circles for Fierro. Fierro off the right wing for Edwards. Back top of the circle for DJ Wagner. Left side, Fierro outside the arc, down the right side of the lane, to the basket. Cut off. Free throw line. Onyesu from 15 buries it.
Well, he's trying to draw you away from the basket. There might be a reason for it. He might can hit that shot.
He knocked down that one. He's only 0 of 1 from the 3, but he knocked down the 15-footer.
Yeah, he was
and
on
UK leads 4-2. Chad Baker-Mazar at the next break for Auburn coming in. Broom, top of the circle. One dribble, now two with the left hand. Hands the ball there to Denver Jones. Stop and pop three. In and
Whoa,
out. Boy, that was down and came back out. Fierro with the rebound.
Got to get back. They're going to run. They're going to run to get a jumper.
Wagner on the wing. Fierro, top of the circle. Now to the right side for Reeves. Goes down. Gets it back out to the top of the circle for Wagner. Shot clock at 12. Wagner gets a screen. Three ball straight away. No. Rebound to Broom for Auburn. Outlet to Donaldson.
Both teams defending very well. Both teams playing man. Both teams picking up at midcourt.
Donaldson behind the back dribble to the top of the circle. 16:52 in the first. 4-2 Kentucky leads it. Donaldson, Broom at the point. Back to Trey out on the right wing. Shot clock at 11 for Auburn. To the wing for Denver Jones. Jones with 8. Down to 7. Penetrates to the hole off the glass. He didn't get it. Rebound Chris Moore in traffic. Loops it out, ball deflected out of bounds off of Kentucky. Auburn ball with 17 to shoot. And that will bring Chad Baker-Mazara into the lineup. UK goes to Rob Dillingham and Reed Shepherd at guards. As Reeve comes out, so does Wagner. And Chris Moore sits down for the Tigers.
And it looks like we can throw the ball inside. They're playing behind us in the post.
Auburn basketball. Chad Baker-Mazara will trigger down the right sideline in front of John Calipari in the Kentucky bench. Bounce pass, Broom. Out to the perimeter for Jalen Williams. Denver Jones picked up by Reed Shepherd. 10 to shoot. Off the left side to Jalen Williams. Hands back to Denver Jones. Down the right side. Fadeaway. 19-footer. No. Rebound to the baseline for Onyesu for Kentucky.
Defense by both teams has been good at this point.
Dillingham to the left wing. Fierro goes baseline. High arching shot. No. The weak side rebound is good by Justin Edwards.
We cannot give him second shots. We got to get only one shot.
6-2 Kentucky. Auburn just 1 of 5 from the field to open things up. Donaldson between the rings, working on Dillingham there. To Denver Jones with a screen from Broom. Denver down the lane. Ball stripped out of there from behind by Reed Shepherd. Shepherd up the floor for UK. Picks up the dribble. Kicks it off the left side for Edwards. To Shepherd at the top. Off the right wing for Dillingham. Picked up by Donaldson. Dillingham, whistle foul on Trey. Got him with the hands at about the free throw line. It'll be the first foul called, and we've got a timeout on the floor. 15:38 to go in the first half of play. Kentucky 6, Auburn 2. First half today presented by Southern Union. Conveniently located just a few miles from Auburn, Southern Union offers classes that easily transfer to the university. Endless opportunities are right up the road. Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
Hey, I'm Charles Barkley. Call for a Redmont and water at bars and restaurants throughout the great state of Alabama. Redmont Vodka, available at select ABC stores and package stores. Redmont Vodka is 8 times distilled, gluten-free, and is made from non-GMO corn. Looking to support a local business? Redmont Distilling is Alabama proud and minority-owned. Learn more online at redmontdistilling.com.
This is the moment you've been waiting for.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our home.
When you step onto the court and into the spotlight, the moment to show that hard work and long days pay off. Because when that final shot leaves your hands and we leave our seats, that powerful moment connects us all.
Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Power for a better Alabama.
Hey, this is Kevin Tutto, owner of Baumhauer's Victory Grill in Auburn. It's basketball season, and we've got you covered with 77 TVs to watch all of your favorite games. Come in and enjoy ice-cold beer and your favorite wings with our happy hour specials from 11 to 6 daily Sunday through Friday. Want to have a watch party to cheer on your Auburn Tigers? Call in and reserve a spot on our new patio for your group party. And the NCAA tournament is right around the corner. We are your official March Madness headquarters with all games televised. Baumhauer's Victory Grill in Auburn. War Eagle.
Chick-fil-A is proud to present this broadcast of Auburn basketball. All Chick-fil-A locations in Alabama proudly support the Auburn Tigers. Eat more chicken and war eagle with Chick-fil-A.
15:38 to go in the first half. Auburn trails Kentucky 6-2. Tigers 1 of 5 from the field. UK is 3 of 7 from the field. Kentucky has out-rebounded Auburn 5-3, and Auburn has turned it over 2 times. So if you get to the first timeout break, does Auburn make any changes, Sonny Smith?
Well, first thing here, their 2 baskets are on second chance. We have got to block them out, and we've got to rebound with the perimeter people as well as the inside people. We have got to make this rebounding game on our side.
Well, let me take it one step further. You're right. 2 baskets off of offensive rebounds and the other basket off of a turnover.
Yeah. Our defense is going to be fine, but we have got to rebound with everybody, not give them any second chances. The game is a little physical. I don't know how long they're going to let them play that way. I noticed that right off.
I don't think that really bothers Auburn to play a physical game.
No, but both teams are playing very physical.
All right, Dylan Cardwell, Chaney Johnson, Chad Baker Mazzara, Aiden Hottaway, and K.D. Johnson, the Auburn 5. Kentucky goes with Onyesu, Reed Shepard, Justin Edwards, Adu Thierro, and Rob Dillingham. Kentucky leads Auburn 6-2. UK ball down the right sideline. Shepard still looking to the baseline, to Dillingham, to the hole, they put it in.
Oh, no. We had them covered really well, and they made a back cut play on us from the side.
8-2, UK. Free throw line, a curl. Pull-up jumper. Chad Baker-Mazzara didn't get it. Rebound, Dillingham. He and Chaney Johnson tie up. And it's a jump ball. And the arrow goes to
there.
UK.
The officials are talking to everybody. It'll be a little physical to start out, so we don't have any problem.
Kentucky 4 of 8 from the field. Auburn 1 of 6.
All right, now we're pressing. We're fronting the guards to try to keep them from getting it inbounds for a steal.
Shepard full length of the floor will trigger. And lobs it ahead for Dillingham across midcourt for UK. He nearly was trapped. He throws it away. Well, out of the trap, he threw it behind and out of bounds.
Absolutely. The press really worked that time. Very difficult to get it in. Got it into a guy that didn't need to have it and got a turnover right off. Our defense is good.
First turnover for Kentucky. Let's see if Auburn can take advantage. Tigers trail 8-2. Cardwell, left wing, K.D. Johnson to the baseline against Shepard. Baseline left. Gets the ball back. Free throw line. Bounce pass Cardwell to the hole. Out of bounds off of Dillon.
Dillon had a dunk right there. He got to be ready now. He's looking up instead of looking down at the ball. We're pressing.
15 minutes in the first half. Auburn trails 8-2. 3 turnovers early on for the Tigers. Shepard across midcourt for UK. Shepard gets a screen. Picked up by Cardwell in a switch. Ball knocked away to the sideline and out of bounds off of Chaney Johnson.
I think they come out and missed that call. I think it touched number 3.
Yeah, Fierro, that's what Chaney Johnson certainly said.
Well, I think it did.
Kentucky will keep it. And it did. It did. We got a replay, and it's no question it touched his right hand on the bounce. Dillingham at the top. Fierro penetrates down the left side. Pull up from about 8. Didn't get it. Rebound to Onyesu for Kentucky. Left wing 3-ball Dillingham. Yes.
Now we cannot allow second shots. We got to block out and agree and rebound aggressively, and we did not do it that time.
7 points on a second chance points for Kentucky. 11-2 Wildcats. Baker Mazzara. Shake and bake down the left side. Drives, kicks it right wing. 3-ball Chaney Johnson. No. Ooh. Rebound Onyesu. Auburn's shooting woes continue. The Tigers are 1 of 7.
We're getting everything but in the basket. They're going rattling in and out.
Dillingham at the top, picked up by KD. Drives around KD. Lobs it off the glass. He didn't get it. And a whistle and a late foul against Auburn. Auburn had the ball going the other way, and they got the foul on KD Johnson.
I think we might have a little whistle happy going here because I don't think that was a foul. No foul. No foul.
Looking at the replay, I'm not sure where the foul was. Bruce Pearl is saying, listen, the guy flopped. Dillingham at the line for 75% free throw shooter. He missed the first. Well, Bruce Pearl really upset at that call there as Chaney Johnson comes out and Jalen Williams is in. Well, that's just a really bad call as we get a couple different replays.
Oh, it was bad.
And it just wasn't the contact that was called. Dillingham second free throw and he missed both.
All right, now settle down and play your game.
11-2 Kentucky. Auburn basketball, 20 on the shot clock. Low post, Jalen Williams, and he's fouled by Fierro. And that may be a makeup call.
Well, it was, but they're fouling very strongly on the post play. They're denying and holding.
Tigers trail 11-2. Auburn 1 of 7 to open up from the field, 0 of 3 from 3. Kentucky to its bench, Jordan Burks is in, replacing Fierro. Burks, 6'8 freshman out of Decatur, Alabama.
We're good on out-of-bounds play.
Inbound, Chad Baker-Mazzara, wide open three, bang!
One of the best things we do is out-of-bounds. We take advantage of the other team on dead ball.
He had a wide open look and he buried it. 11-5 UK, 15 and a half minutes to go in the first. Burks picks up the dribble, now to Reed Shepard. Shepard loops it out to the top for Reeves. Reeves drives on Chad Baker to the basket. He banked it up, it was blocked. Rebounded by Chad Baker. Up the floor on the left-hand dribble. To the left wing. Behind-the-back dribble. Behind-the-back pass, and he threw it away. Kentucky with the breakaway. Reeves runs it down against KD Johnson and picked up the foul on KD. Second foul on KD.
Well, this is not a game to throw the behind-the-back pass. This is a game to play basketball fundamentally sound and aggressively.
He fouled a behind-the-back dribble with a behind-the-back pass and turned it over. Auburn's fourth turnover early on, and Antonio Reeves, 88%, a team best at the line for two.
Two things you don't want to have a lot of is turnovers and fouls against Kentucky.
Free throw is good by Antonio Reeves, a senior from Chicago, a transfer from Illinois State. 43 of his field goal attempts this year are threes, and he's been in double digits in every game but one this year for UK.
Well, he's a very good free throw shooter to go with that.
He knocks home both free throws and makes it a 13-5 Kentucky lead with 13-11 in the first.
All right, run your offense.
Cross midcourt, Aiden Holloway. Near the center circle. Off the right wing, Cardwell. Back to Holloway at the point. Aiden to the right wing, Chad Baker-Mazzara. Low post, Cardwell. One dribble, head fake. Up and in.
What a great job. Got it under the basket, pump fake, got them off their feet, laid it in. A great job by Dylan Cardwell.
SunSouth drive of the game, SunSouth John Deere, preferred tractor of the Tigers. Find your local dealer at sunsouth.com. Bradshaw, top of the circle for the Wildcats. Left wing, Dillingham, picked up by KD. Penetrates, kicks it to Wagner. Down the lane, Wagner up, lost it, got it back, seven to shoot. Dillingham penetrates, up with a right hand, didn't get it. Rebound, Chad Baker-Mazzara.
Our defense is excellent.
Holloway penetrates all the way to the hall. Banked it, it's blocked. Rebound jam, Jalen Williams!
Got the crowd in the game. They've got me in the game.
13-9 UK. Wildcat ball. Dillingham. Ball knocked away. Chad Baker-Mazzara. Baker-Mazzara's got a breakaway. Chad behind the back dribble. Gets it into the corner. Free ball, Holloway, in and out. Rebound, Cardwell, out to the top. Jalen for three. Yeah, it's no good. And the rebound to Kentucky. Wagner for UK. Down the lane against Cardwell. Put it up, he got it.
Mazzara got hurt on the ball under the basket. I think he's wanting to come out of the game.
Leor Berman, I think, will come in. Now Leor goes back to the bench.
He's okay. He motions, let him know at the bench. He's okay. I thought he was hurt.
15-9 UK Auburn ball. Chad Baker-Mazzara right wing. Gets a screen from Cardwell. In the key. Into the corner. KD Johnson. KD loses it. Gets the ball back. Stolen. UK basketball. Wagner ahead. Left wing three ball. It's good by Reeves.
Yeah, they're going to hurt you now. You got to take care of the basketball. Run our offense.
9-point lead, Kentucky, 18-9. 5-point run by UK and a timeout called by Bruce Pearl. 11:01 to go in the first half. Kentucky 18, Auburn 9. Stay tuned. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
Here's a clip from a recent Talking Tigers podcast with Andy Burcham.
Ralph Jordan Jr.
I can remember when the announcement came. We had 15,000 people in our front yard over on Woodfield. And I can remember my mother running around telling them not to step in her flower beds and things, and she might as well have been howling at the moon. You know, I mean, they were there for that one purpose, and they wanted to get old Shug and carry him down College Street back to Toomer's Corner, but he wouldn't go. You know, it was pandemonium. I don't think the population of Auburn was much more than that at that time. it was a special moment. And there was, you know, some near misses and things along the way, but that one, just everything fell into place, and that's what has to happen.
A new episode of the Talking Tigers podcast is released every Monday. Wherever you listen to podcasts, like and subscribe to the Talking Tigers podcast, only from the Auburn Sports Network.
Today's highlight is brought to you by Toyota. At home or on the road, they're never the underdog. Toyota, let's go places. Get 3.99% APR for 36 months on a new 2024 Toyota RAV4. Offer valid through March 4th, 2024. Zero down for well-qualified buyers with approved credit and financing through Southeast Toyota Finance. $29.52 monthly payment for every $1,000 finance. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and dealer fees. See dealer for details.
Welcome back to Neville Arena. Wildcats with an early 18-9 lead over Auburn here in the jungle. Jacob Hillman here with the check. A quick check of the Yellowwood scoreboard. In the SEC, number 8 Tennessee hosting Vanderbilt and is up big early, 35-12 with 4:40 to go in the first half there. Jonas Idu already has 6 points and 6 rebounds, well on his way to a double-double. Now let's take a look at some of the top 25 action that has taken place today, starting with some finals. The top-ranked team in the country, UConn, hosted number 4 Marquette and absolutely dominated, getting its 14th straight win, 81-53. Donovan Klingon had 17 points and 10 rebounds. Number 3 Houston also had a dominant performance over Texas, winning 82-61 in Houston. That's a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard. Back to Andy Burcham and Sonny Smith.
Auburn trails 18-9. It's the biggest lead thus far for UK. Auburn has not led in this first half point. If there's a stat that jumps off the page, Sonny Smith, it's Auburn's 5 turnovers, and Kentucky has outscored Auburn on turnovers 12-0.
Take care of the basketball. And these are turnovers that are not created by tough defense. We've turned this ball over with behind-the-back passes, errant passes that have not gone where we started. I think all we got to do is settle down, play the half-court game a little bit, and not let them get out and run on us, because they're right now hurting us in all phases.
Rob Dillingham, Antonio Reeves with 5 points apiece leads Kentucky. Auburn's leading scorer is Chad Baker-Mazzara with 3 points and 2 rebounds. And the Auburn 5 coming on the floor include Jani Broome, Trey Donaldson, Leor Berman, Denver Jones, and Jalen Williams.
Kentucky's points are coming in the paint. We have got to keep them off the boards and not getting the wide open shots in the posted areas on our own drives.
Auburn outscored 10-6 in the paint early on. Kentucky on defense, Auburn trails by 9. Kentucky's gone to a zone.
It looks like a zone, but we'll have to see the first pass and see what happens.
Free throw line, Jalen low post for Broome. Jani double team to the wing. 3 ball, Denver. Nope, weak side rebound, Kentucky.
We're only getting one shot.
Wagner up the floor for UK. Down the left side of the lane, lobs it on Yesu. Ball stripped and a foul against Jani.
And that might be
first foul on Jani.
Joe very rarely makes a bad call, but I did not see a foul. I saw a deflection and a steal right there.
Auburn struggling from the field right now. 4 of 13 and 1 of 6 from 3.
No foul on that last play. Referees are into the game too much.
Onyesu's free throw is missed. He's from Nigeria, played on the Nigerian national team. Had a 10-block game against Ole Miss.
10 blocks. I couldn't believe that.
10 blocks earlier this week. And he makes the second free throw.
He's got a good-looking shot. I don't know how good it's going to be as far as going in the basket, but it looks good.
Aiden Hottaway in, Trey Donaldson out. Auburn trails by 10 at home.
They're pressing.
Hottaway double-teamed along the baseline. Gets the ball to Jalen Williams. Races forward across midcourt to the right wing, Denver Jones. To Jalen, now between the circles, Hottaway. Tigers down 10 with 10:26 in the first. Hottaway, right wing Denver. Low post, Broome, fouled by Edwards. Down the right side of the lane. First foul on Justin Edwards, freshman out of Philadelphia.
It's very easy to see what they part of their game plan. They're trying to take Broom out of the game by fronting him, bumping him, pushing him away from the basket. We got to find a way to get him open, get him going.
Out of bounds baseline right, inbound into the mid lane for Broom. Double team, left wing Denver. Passed up the three, bounce pass to Broom, left side of the lane. 13 to shoot. Janai off the left hand, block and a goaltend.
We got to get it to him because once the ball is reversed, they lose the double team that they have, and we got a post up.
Janai cuts the lead to 8, 4 points for the Auburn junior out of Plant City, Florida. 19 to 11, Kentucky. 10-13 in the first half.
We're pressing. We're pressing to steal.
Wagner will work on Denver Jones up the floor. Across midcourt with 2 seconds to spare. Wagner between the circles for Dillingham. Right wing Edwards, top of the circle. Off the left side, Dillingham brings it top of the key, make that Fierro. Hands the ball there to Reeves. Back to the top for Wagner, 6 to shoot. Wagner gets a screen. Off the left wing, free throw line. Forces up a shot, it was an air ball, rebounded by Broom. Auburn the other way.
Great defense by the Tigers.
Broom at the top, whistle 3. And as the shot was just about going up by Janai, Jalen Williams was flying out of bounds on the baseline.
They're being very physical in the post. They're riding you out when you get on the block, and they're pushing quite a bit. We're going to have to become better aware of that and push back.
Foul whistled against Wagner, his first. Berman out. Chad Baker-Mazzara in for Auburn. Down 8 with 9:38 in the first half.
Both teams still playing man for man.
Out of bounds, baseline right, Chad Baker-Mazzara. Out to the top, Jalen Williams. Wide open 3, barely drew iron. Rebound, Chad Baker. Onto the wing, 3 ball. Missed by Holloway.
We can't throw it in the ocean right now, but we will.
Auburn 1 of 8 from 3 right now. Wide open 3 ball, Edwards left side, didn't get it. And the rebound pulled in by Baker-Mazzara. Holloway races forward for Auburn. Behind the back dribble, off the left wing, Jones. Low post, Broom. Against Onyesu, into the corner, Williams, top of the circle, left wing, wide open 3, Holloway, short, rebound Broom, Janai, 1 dribble, up, in and out, Onyesu gets the rebound for Kentucky.
We're getting the shots, we just can't hit them right now, but we will.
Wagner, to the right wing for Fierro, top of the circle for Wagner.
They run some time off, and then they will drive it to the basket.
Wagner gets a screen. Picked up by Williams in a switch. Picks up his dribble on the sideline. Hands to Reeves down the lane. Reeves high off the glass. He didn't get it. Rebound out of there. Auburn the other way. Holloway to the right wing. Inside the arc to the wing. Jalen head fake at 3 and a whistle.
Out of bounds probably.
They stop the clock. Auburn has a player down. And it is Chad Baker-Mazzara under the Kentucky goal. Why they stop play when Auburn had the ball and was driving? Boy, I'm not certain.
Well, we don't know when they stopped the clock. We didn't see it, and they could have stopped. They could have done what they were supposed to do. The injury took place.
Now, right now, the concern is Chad Baker-Mazzara down and being attended to by Clark Pearson, Auburn's athletic trainer, and the team doctor, Michael Goodlett. And I'll be honest, friends, I didn't see what happened to CBM.
Nobody did.
And they're going to look at it now in a review just to take a look.
Well, he's not getting up. It's probably he's looking like he's in the head area.
We're at the 8:29 mark of the first half. Auburn trails 19 to 11.
Well, one thing we've got to do is they're going to run time off, and then they're going to drive it to the basket. We've got to give them one shot. When we get it down on our side, we have got to move the basketball a little fast because they're letting us go where we want to, just not letting us get into the lane on the dribble.
Time out on the floor, friends. Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
When you live in SEC country, you feel it everywhere you go. The traditions and rivalries surround you. As much as you celebrate the game, Regions celebrates your financial wins even more. And like SEC fans, we'll never quit. Because in an SEC world, we're the SEC Bank. Regions, official bank of the SEC, member FDIC.
You've created a comfortable home office. Now let Carrier provide the cash bonus. For a limited time, you can claim up to $1,550 in cool cash rebates on a qualified Carrier home comfort system. There's never been a better time to upgrade to year-round premium comfort and energy savings.
Carrier, a proud partner of Auburn Athletics and special needs assistance stations for you. Turn to the experts with Carrier.
When the game goes into overtime, but the game goes into overtime, the choice to enjoy is easy. Bud Light, easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Order Bud Light online today. Enjoy responsibly. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Back to Neville Arena for more Auburn basketball.
8:29 to go in the first half of play. The official game stats have Auburn trailing 19-11. The scoreboard has it 19-9, which would indicate to me that they have reversed the goaltend against Kentucky. And apparently what happened to Chad Baker-Mazzara underneath the Kentucky goal, well, nothing's going to come of it as far as a foul or any kind of flagrant foul on the play. So that's a double whammy for Auburn, because Auburn loses a basket, apparently. Yeah, it's 19-9. And the Tigers, who were in the act of about to shoot the basketball when the clock stopped, when the clock was stopped because Chad Baker-Mazzara was down.
Well, I couldn't see it, and I don't know what, but one thing I do see is we're turning the ball over, and they're turning it into points.
5 turnovers for Auburn, 12 points off turnovers for Kentucky.
Yeah, that's been the big thing in the game right now. Taking care of the basketball is number one, and I think we need to get some second shots, because they are pushing us out on the perimeter so that we can't reverse the ball. And I think if we can get in the lane on the dribble or get us some second shots, right, we can break down their defense.
That second basket by Janai Broome, which was a goaltend on Kentucky, has been taken away. I don't recall who got the rebound after it, but it's kind of null and void right now. Auburn ball down 10, 19-9. No one gets you closer to the game than SiriusXM SEC Radio. Tune in for news, talk, and analysis from the offseason through the regular season into the postseason. Get a free trial at SiriusXM.us/SEC Radio 2023. Auburn ball, right wing, and Chris Moore, top of the circle, Jalen. Bounce pass to Janai, left side of the key, 10 to shoot. Janai backing Yanesu down. Nice pass, Chris Moore up. It was blocked, he goes up and he draws the foul.
Well, they're making sure that they do not allow Janai turn to the baseline. They're pushing him back in towards the middle where they can double team him. We got to take advantage of that by kicking it out and shooting something wide open.
Chris Moore at the line for 2 for the Tigers. The senior out of the academies of West Memphis puts in the free throw.
Well, if they call him, we're going to go to the line a lot.
Wagner is out for Kentucky, and Dillingham back in for the Cats.
One thing on offense that Kentucky's doing, they're running a little bit of time off the clock by passing the ball around the perimeter, and then they're looking to go on the dribble drive.
Moore missed the second free throw. 19-10 UK. They've led by as much as 10. Auburn has not led in this game. Shepherd between the circles. Behind the back dribble, top of the circle. Bounce pass to Dillingham, outside the arc, right side against Denver Jones. Head fake, shoots from 16, he missed it, rebound Denver.
Good defense with the Tigers.
Denver up the floor, right sideline. Chris Moore back to Denver Jones outside the arc. Denver, Auburn's point guard right now. Working on Dillingham, 17 to shoot. To the wing, Chris Moore. Low post for Broome. Along the baseline, gets double teamed. Off the left side, KD, top of the circle, Denver for 3. Yes.
Good ball movement, good patience, good discipline with the basketball.
Trims the lead to 6. 7-16. Shepherd, pull-up jumper from 12. Wide open, he got it on.
He's good off the dribble, especially getting into the lane and pull-up. He's a pull-up jumper. You cannot allow him to get that free.
21-13 Kentucky, 7:02 in the first half of play. Jones between the rings. Left-hand dribble, top of the key. Jalen Williams, low post KD. Head fake, off the glass. He didn't get it. No contact. And here's Kentucky the other way.
Their defense has been solid.
Yep.
We're not getting good shots.
Dillingham between the rings. Shepherd on the left wing, picked up by Chris Moore. Drives on Moore. Lobs it wildly up there. He missed it. Denver Jones gets the rebound. Here's Auburn the other way. Jones lobs it. Broom to the hole. Yes!
We're beating them down the floor. That's something. That will change things.
Back to a six-point game. 21-15 UK. 6:21 in the first half. Fierro between the circles. Working on to Jalen Williams through the lane. Off the left side to Dillingham. Dillingham down the lane off the glass. He missed it. Rebound off of Broom and out of bounds.
Well, Broom was fouled on a push from behind, yeah, or we would have rebounded that basketball. They cannot let that go when it costs you turnovers.
21-15 Kentucky, 6:09 in the first. Chaney Johnson is in for Auburn, replacing Jalen Williams. Reed Shepherd will trigger baseline right. 20 on the shot clock for Kentucky. Shepherd lobs it out to midcourt for Dillingham. Looks to the bench, gets the call. 16 to shoot. Dillingham a screen. Picked up by KD. Now to Fierro down the lane against Chaney. Yes, and a foul on the play.
My goodness, I thought that was a block shot, and he powered it in the bucket.
Did.
Our defense is not bad. It's not as bad as the score is showing.
Fierro's father, Almi, played basketball for Memphis under John Calipari. There's a couple second-generation players on this team whose fathers played at Memphis, and their sons are now at Kentucky. Fierro at the line, a three-point opportunity. And he makes it.
All right, get a little patience in our offense. We can get it where we want to if we'll move the ball quickly.
24-15 UK. KD at the top for Chaney Johnson. Right wing for Moore. Low post, Broom outside the lane. Kicks it left side, KD. Almost threw it out of bounds. KD with a good save. On the wing against Fierro. 10 to shoot. Behind the back dribble. 19-footer by KD. Didn't draw iron out of bounds. And Kentucky has it.
Well, you got to give Kentucky a little bit of help. Congratulations. They're playing great defense right now.
Yes, they are, Sonny.
We have got to get better shots.
5:36 in the first half. Kentucky leads Auburn by 9 with the basketball. Dillingham will bring it forward. Auburn right now shooting 27% from the field at 6 of 22. Shepherd around Moore, out to the top. Fierro penetrates. Ball knocked away. There's a steal. Moore, and Chris has it taken away from behind by Shepherd. To the right wing for Reeves, alley-oop, and a dunk by Fierro, and he's fouled by Chris Moore.
Turnovers are hurting us right now. Foolish fouls are hurting us right now. Got to take better care of the basketball.
Find your piece of paradise in the Alabama Gulf Coast with Mindy Jones of RE/MAX Paradise. Visit Mindy at paradise.com. Fierro, an opportunity for two consecutives and one opportunities. Kentucky by 11, the biggest lead of the first half for UK. Auburn right now with 6 turnovers in the early going, and the Tigers have been outscored 14-0 off turnovers here in the first half.
We're not playing Auburn basketball right now, but we will.
Fierro with the second and one. He has 6 points. Sophomore out of Pittsburgh, and Kentucky's largest lead is 12, 27-15.
Right now, they're letting us throw the ball into the post, but they're locking up everybody on the perimeter.
Donaldson back in at the point. Lobs it left side. Jones goes baseline. Wide open for about 18, in and out. Rebound tapped and out of bounds off Kentucky. Auburn ball. Boy, Auburn's shooting woes continue.
And we're not taking bad shots. We're getting shots. We just aren't able to knock them down right now.
6 of 23 from the field. Auburn out of bounds, baseline right. Chaney Johnson, and they'll go to their bench to Zvonimir Ivicic, freshman at 7'2" from Croatia.
All right, now, we've been really good on out of bounds play. Let's see if we can do it again.
Chaney Johnson into the corner for Donaldson to Broom. Almost got tackled by Ivicic, drives to the hole and scores.
Well, they're putting so much pressure on the perimeter. We can get the ball on the drive, or we can get it throwing it into the middle.
10-point Kentucky lead, 27-17. Ivicic picked up by Broom out at the top. Knocks the ball away. Ivicic knocked away again into the backcourt. Picked up by Dillingham. 14 to shoot. Dillingham against Berman for three. Didn't get it. Rebound Donaldson for Auburn. Up the floor, top of the circle, down the lane. Loses it and fouled on the
got foul.
I don't know if that'll be a shooting foul or not. Well, it's the sixth foul against UK. The foul goes against Dillingham. It's his first, and it is a two-shot foul.
Yeah,
Donaldson at the line.
I think that's correct. He was fouled going down the floor, but they didn't call that.
Broom will come out after the first free throw by Donaldson, and Cardwell will come in. Free throw by Trey. Good.
We just got to settle down, run our offense, and play defense without fouling, and we'll be okay.
Ivicic is out, and Onyesu back in for Kentucky. Free throw from Trey. He missed it. Rebound. Out of bounds off of Auburn. Boy, Leor Berman got almost tackled on that rebound attempt.
He really did.
Goodness gracious.
He really did. There should have been something called there.
4:19 in the first. Auburn trails by nine. 27-18, UK ball. Dillingham will work on Denver Jones up the floor. Across midcourt. Kentucky has led by as much as 12. Auburn has not led in the game. Dillingham, double team, still looking. Picked up by Denver Jones. Drives, leans, shoots, misses. Rebound Donaldson. Auburn the other way. Donaldson off the right wing. Dillingham on his back, 15-footer, didn't go. Rebound Berman, foul.
That's a foul.
They got him that time.
What?
And Leor will go to the line to shoot two, to shoot 1-1, and taking us to a timeout. Kentucky 27, Auburn 18, East Alabama, Auburn basketball, brought to you by East Alabama Health. With more than 80 positions added in the past 5 years, they're growing their healthcare team to meet the growing needs of Auburn, Opelika, and the surrounding area. Stay tuned. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Play Club.
Here's a clip from a recent Talking Tigers podcast with Andy Burcham.
We're very glad to have today Auburn University's president, Dr. Chris Roberts. You, for example, Andy, you interface with various people on campus in different ways, and your thread weaves and touches different people's threads in different ways at Auburn, and that makes up your Auburn experience. And another person does that in another way through a different set of experiences. It may not ever interface with your thread, but somehow or another, this all gets weaved together into this wonderful, beautiful tapestry that is Auburn. I'm just really overwhelmed at how beautiful this place is in terms of how it affects other people. And so I, myself, my thread, has been touched by so many different people through the years, and it's just made for a really rich experience for me. I want that for our students.
A new episode of the Talking Tigers podcast is released every Monday. Wherever you listen to podcasts, like and subscribe to the Talking Tigers podcast, only from the Auburn Sports Network.
Things we take for granted, ordinary opportunities for parents and their children, can be a foster child's extraordinary. You have the power to do something positive that will change the life of a young person right here in Alabama. Open your heart and open your home to a foster child today. For more information, visit www.dhr.alabama.gov or call 1-866-64-AL-KIDS. Brought to you by the Alabama Department of Human Resources, the Alabama Broadcasters Association, and this station.
Welcome back to Neville Arena. Kentucky on top of Auburn, 27-18. We're 3:52 away from the Connecticut Sausage Halftime Report. Jacob Hillman here with a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard. Update Knoxville. The Volunteers have taken a 51-20 lead to halftime. Josiah Jordan James has 10 points and 3 steals at the break. Some more top 25 scores. Number 7, North Carolina defeats Virginia Tech 96-81 behind 25 points and 12 rebounds from Armando Bacot. In Durham, number 9, Duke. Visited Florida State and won 76-67. Jared McCain had 35 points and 3 steals. We'll have a full check of the Yellowwood scoreboard, including all SEC and top 25 action during the Connecticut Sausage Halftime Report. Now back to the voice of the Tigers, Andy Burcham, and the Hall of Fame coach, Sonny Smith.
3:52 to go in the first half. Kentucky has led for almost the entire first half of play. Wildcats have led by as many as 12. Currently lead Auburn by 9, and Leor Berman will be at the free throw line Murray won in bonus coming out of the timeout break.
Well, first and only thing I'd mention right off would be we got to take care of the basketball. 15 of their points are on turnovers. So we've got to get that taken care of first. And the second chance, we got to keep them off the board, not let them get any second shot, because they're not taking good shots. They're taking shots basically on the outside or on shots that are drives.
Said earlier that Berman would be at the line. That was only Kentucky's sixth foul, so Auburn has it out of bounds, baseline right. Cardwell, Jones, Baker Mazar back in after taking an elbow to the face. Johnson for the Tigers. Chaney Johnson, the inbound. Cardwell leans in, goes up and scores, and gets
and
fouled in the play.
And got fouled. Well, I probably say it too much, but there's not a better team in the country on out-of-bounds plays than the Auburn Tigers. We do it better, and we do it mostly successful. Even when we miss, we get good shots.
The foul is against Onyesu, so it's his first. And now Dylan Cardwell for the and-one opportunity for Auburn.
Yeah, we're right in this thing, and we haven't played any of our great basketball at this point.
Dylan missed the free throw. Free throw, not Auburn's best suit right now. The Tigers are 2 of 5 from the line. Down 7, Auburn on defense. Shepherd to Fierro against Cardwell. Drives in the lane, head fake. Back to the wing for Shepherd. Pull-up jumper by Shepherd off the glass. It's good.
Shepherd is very good on the drive and banking the ball. I've watched him all year. You cannot let him go to the baseline side. Force him back towards the middle where you can get some help.
Yeah, he gets the rap of being nothing but a three-point shooter. Yeah. He's a very good shooter, period.
Well, if you let him go to the sideline, he really is.
Baker Mazar at the top, off the left side, loops it to the corner. Three ball, Denver, got it!
Great look, great pass, cross-court pass.
All the way the other end. Reeves blocked and a foul on Dylan.
Well, it was a foul, but they've been letting that go up to this point. The body created the foul as a block shot.
Well, they got back in a hurry, didn't they?
Oh.
And Reeves, a great free throw shooter at the line for two on the first foul against Dylan Cardwell. He used his elbow, did Reeves. Everybody in the ballpark sees it. Free throw by Reeves is missed.
What they didn't say was what happened before, and the referees might have been correct, but they could have called the other first.
Cardwell out, Broom is in for Auburn. Donaldson out.
That's an offensive foul.
Yeah, it really is. I mean, they completely missed the call. Reeves to take the lead back to 7, and he does.
All right, get a good shot.
Boy, boy.
Get a good shot. We'll get right back in this team.
30-23, Kentucky, just under 3 minutes in the first half. Denver Jones running the point. Jones, right wing for Jalen Williams. Top of the circle, Broom, foul underneath.
Well, the physicality of the game is getting a little bit more than these guys are going to allow. So they're going to start calling this now, I think.
Foul goes against Edwards. His second. Chad Baker Mazar gets a couple.
Kentucky has been really roughhousing us on the offensive when they're on defense on the half court.
Free throw is good by Chad Baker Mazar. Cuts the lead back to 6. Katie Johnson in the Auburn lineup. Along with Broom, along with Baker Mazar, along with Jones, and along with Jalen.
From a stat standpoint, we're not playing good basketball, but we're in this game doing what we do best.
Cut the lead to 5, 2:46. Kentucky 30, Auburn 25. Shepherd, left wing, drives. Oh, he walked. Get it into the corner. Reeves goes baseline. Reeves kicks it out to Dillingham, to Reeves in the corner for 3, and it's good. Boy, they got away with two big walks there. Goodness gracious.
Our defense is forcing them into those walks. They're just not calling them.
33-25 Kentucky. Chad Baker Mazar, left wing. Into the lane, Jalen Williams. Backs his man in. Turnaround with the left hand. He didn't get it. Rebound tap up by Broom. No. Tap up again by Broom. Rebound Kentucky.
Oh, we had all kind of chances there. It just didn't drop. Second chance. We're getting those chances.
Shepherd Double team, ball knocked away. Comes out onto the left side to Dillingham. Down the lane to the hole off the glass. He got it, 10-point lead.
Dillingham is so quick, and he goes hard with a dribble. We got a little help. Have a little help on him.
Dillingham with seven off the bench. Kentucky by 10 again. Auburn had it down to five. Denver Jones out at the top, working on Clark or on Shepherd. Underneath, off the left side, Broom. Janai puts it up. Three ball. Nope. Weak side rebound. Kentucky. There was nobody there for Auburn to rebound.
Well, their defense has been all set up to stop
Janai. Kentucky by 10. They get the ball back at midcourt. Dillingham hands down the left side for Reeves. Back to Dillingham, 13 to shoot. Drives on KD and a reach in on KD. Third foul on KD Johnson. You hear the Auburn fans saying, if you call that one side, you better call it at the other end of the floor. And that's what Bruce Pearl is saying as well. Boy, oh boy. We haven't seen this much this year, especially in this building.
You haven't seen this crowd into it as that.
Let me say
they're
this.
They're wrong.
Kentucky's playing really well right now. I don't want to take anything away from Kentucky.
Not. But you're right, though.
Dillingham for two.
It's the officials' fault because they let them go early in the game. They were really pounding one another. Now they're calling them.
Auburn has missed his last five shots. Kentucky, on the other hand, has hit his last five of seven. Kentucky on a 6-0 run and make it seven as Dillingham knocks it home.
All right, now get a good shot. Get back in this thing the way we always do.
106 in the first half. Auburn down by 12. Whistle foul.
What's happening here?
Reeves is called for the foul at the other end of the floor.
The officials are trying to make up for what they didn't call early, and that's going to change this game because the players can't adjust to that kind of up-down officiating.
How about not missing the first one?
Yeah.
And Chad Bacon is at the free throw line for two. Excuse me, a one and bonus for Auburn. First free throw. Good. Baker Mazzara with 6 points off the bench for Auburn, the Tigers' leading scorer, along with Denver Jones and Janai Broom.
We really are not playing good Auburn basketball, but we're right in this game. So all we got to do is just keep plugging, and we'll be right back in it.
Chad Baker makes both. Cuts the lead back to 10 with a minute to go in the first half. Kentucky 37, Auburn 27. Reeves at the top. Left wing Dillingham to Shepherd. Shepherd off the right wing for Dillingham. Outside the arc, drives on Holloway. Fade away. Got it. Nicely played.
That's a play that you don't defense much. But that was just a great offensive play. A drive in the lane and jump off. Back. I can't even talk.
Kentucky by 12. Holloway stop and pop three. Nobody's fouled by Dillingham.
We can get that shot with a high pick and come up because they're so concerned with Janai Broom that they're not helping on that play.
Holloway at the free throw line for three for Auburn, 76% from the stripe this year out from the Charlotte, North Carolina freshman. First of three, good. Bench points right now. Kentucky outscoring Auburn 15 to 12. Points off turnovers, 15-0 in favor of Kentucky. And Holloway misses the second free throw.
Well, they're out doing us in a lot of different things now. But we get to play in Auburn basketball. We can get right back in this game. And that's what we need to do.
Auburn 7 of 11 from the line. Kentucky 8 of 12. Holloway can cut the lead to 10. And he does. Nestles in. Auburn 1 or 3 of 12 from 3. Kentucky 3 of 8.
Now we're pressing, trying to steal if we can. Slow them down if we can.
Kentucky ball. Inbound Reeves. Brings it up the floor now to Shepherd. Reed Shepherd across midcourt. Timeout Kentucky with 24 on the shot clock. 26 and 3/10 seconds in the first half. Hey, War Eagle Plus is here. Sign up for the new streaming video and content platform for Auburn Athletics, offering fans and insiders look into the student athletes and coaches on the plains. For more information, And to sign up, visit WarEaglePlus.com. Kentucky, 14 of 29 from the field of 48%, 3 of 8 from 3, 8 of 12 from the free throw line. Kentucky and Auburn tied with 20 rebounds apiece. Auburn, 9 of 32 from the field.
Nothing.
Well, just there. 3 of 12 from the three-point line and 8 of 12 from the free throw line. The difference in the ball game right now is turnovers. Auburn with 6 first-half turnovers, Kentucky with 3. And the Wildcats have outscored Auburn off of turnovers 15-0.
15-0. That is the difference right there.
Kentucky has led by as many as 12, currently lead by 10.
Well, we got to make up 10 points. We can't make up the way we have played early in the first half. But we can get back to that because they're not going to be able to stop us when we start moving the ball.
Shepherd will trigger near the Auburn bench down the left sideline. Into the backcourt for Dillingham, almost to the Auburn free throw line.
No fouls now.
Across midcourt, left side, Shepherd, picked up by Chad Baker. To Reeves at the top. Fierro outside the arc, top of the circle, Dillingham. 10 to shoot.
All right, they're going to set a high pick and try to drive off of it or get the roll.
5 seconds on the shot clock. Low post, Onyesu. Into the corner and out of bounds. Boy, Onyesu has a dunk.
Yes.
And tried to get it to Shepherd for a three and threw it out of bounds. Full length of the floor to go for Auburn. 2.9 seconds in the first half. Moore will come out and Berman is in for Auburn.
Now they will press really hard. So we want to get the ball in a position where we can get it up with 2 seconds.
2.9 to be exact. Inbound Baker Mazzara near midcourt, lobs it. Three good to go. Off the left side of the iron and out. And the first half comes to a close. Boy, one of Auburn's toughest first halves here at Neville Arena in a long, long time. For the first time this year, at home, Auburn trails by double digits at the half. Kentucky 39, Auburn 29. Time now for the Kaneka Sausage Halftime Report. And here is Jacob Hillman.
Thanks, Andy. And as you said, a spot that Auburn has not been in many times this year at Neville Arena, if at all, Tigers will have to mount a 10-point comeback in the second half to stay undefeated inside Neville Arena this season. Now time for a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard. Let's go through a full check, starting with the SEC Finals. Number 15, Alabama, took down Texas A&M 100-75 this morning. Mark Sears scored 23 points, had 4 assists and 3 steals. Texas A&M dominant on the rebounds, grabbing 26 on the offensive glass, but it wasn't enough. Crimson Tide moves to 10-2 in SEC play. Texas A&M falls to 6-6. Florida traveled to Athens, defeated Georgia 88-82. One of the hottest teams in SEC play moves to 8-4 in the conference, and the Bulldogs fall to 4-8. Arkansas traveled to the Hump in Starkville and fell to the Bulldogs 71-67. Razorbacks got 39 points from Makai Mitchell and Khalif Battle, but that was it. And Cam Matthews led the way for the Bulldogs with 17 points and 10 rebounds. In Columbia, South Carolina, the 11th-ranked Gamecocks fell to LSU as Jordan Wright hit game-winning free throws with 5 seconds to go. He scored 14 points and grabbed 7 rebounds. B.J. Mack had 18 points and 9 rebounds as well. Going on right now, number 8, Tennessee, up big on Vanderbilt, 66-28 with 14:03 to go in that ball game. Josiah Jordan-James, 13 points, 7 rebounds, and 3 steals. Going on later tonight at 7:30 Central, Ole Miss will host Missouri. The Rebels will try to get to 6-6 with Texas A&M and Mississippi State against the winless Tigers. Now for some top 25 scores, starting with the finals. Number 1, UConn gets its 14th straight win against number 4, Marquette, taking down them 81-53. Donovan Klingon had 17 points and 10 rebounds. Number 3, Houston defeated Texas 82-61 down there in Houston. Number 6, Kansas takes down number 25, Oklahoma, 67-57. Hunter Dickinson, as you would imagine, had a big game, 20 points, 16 rebounds on the boards. Number 7, North Carolina hosted Virginia Tech, took down the Hokies 96-81. Armando Bacot had 25 points and 12 rebounds. Number 9, Duke defeated Florida State on the road, 76-67. Jared McCain, 35 points and 3 steals. Number 10, Iowa State took down Texas Tech 82-74 in Lubbock. Number 16, Dayton, survived Fordham 78-70. Number 17, Creighton, won in convincing fashion over Butler 79-57. An upset in Stillwater. Oklahoma State defeats number 19 BYU 93-83. Jamyron Keller and Brandon Garrison combined for 20-plus points apiece, I should say, and led the Cowboys to a win. Number 20, Wisconsin falls in a high-scoring affair in Big Ten play to Iowa, 88-86. In overtime, Owen Freeman, a big game, 20 points, 12 rebounds, and 6 assists. And going on currently in the top 25, number 14, Illinois in a tight one with Maryland, leading 57-53 with 11:03 to go there. Number 12, Baylor on top of West Virginia, 45-34 as that second half just gets underway. Well, the crossover season is all the way here with Arena Sports hitting the home stretch and spring sports getting their seasons underway. We'll cover all the happenings and more when we take a look around Auburn Athletics.
Presenting the all-new Aubie's Kids Club. Benefits include an exclusive Aubie-branded swag box or bag, T-shirt, membership card, access to exclusive Kids Club events, as well as free admission to non-conference baseball, softball, and women's basketball games. Members also get a monthly newsletter from Aubie, a special invitation to Aubie's birthday party, and a personalized birthday card. Two membership options are available. Learn more and register at aubieskidsclub.com.
When the game goes into overtime. But the game goes into overtime. The choice to enjoy is easy. Bud Light, easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Order Bud Light online today. Enjoy responsibly. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
By now, your daily routine is probably a little too routine. Don't you want to change? Don't you want to start playing by your own rules and escape the routine so your fantasy becomes reality? Where every night is an adventure, where new flavors are ready to be tasted, where it feels like you're a winner. Take a chance. Reward yourself. Make your routine anything but routine. Escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
Kaneka Sausage is a fan favorite for tailgating, always great on the grill, and it's the official sausage dog and hot dog of the Auburn Tigers. Kaneka Sausage is made from the finest cuts of pork, their patented blend of seasonings, and smoked over a pure hickory fire for that true southern flavor. Be sure to visit the Kaneka gift shop in Evergreen, Alabama, right off I-65 at exit 96. Enjoy a crowd-pleasing Kaneka Sausage dog while watching the Tigers and make Kaneka part of your game day. Kaneka Sausage, since 1947, a real winner.
Welcome back to the Kaneka Sausage Halftime Show. Auburn trails Kentucky 39-29 at the break. And Auburn has just honored Aubie for his 11th national championship. Most beloved mascot in all of college sports. Jacob Hillman here with the courtside at Neville Arena as we take a look around Auburn Athletics. This look around Auburn Athletics is brought to you by Auburn Bank, champions of you. Auburn baseball took the series against Eastern Kentucky behind Joseph Gonzalez. His first outing in 364 days, he pitched five innings, allowed two hits, and one run. The series finale is tomorrow at 1 Central with Andy Burcham and Brad Law on the Auburn Sports Network. Now, here's Britt Bowen on women's basketball.
Auburn women's basketball heads to Tuscaloosa for a big one Sunday afternoon against Alabama. The Tigers are coming off back-to-back wins over Missouri and Kentucky. With five games left in the regular season, Auburn is 16-8 and 5-6 in the SEC. The Tigers are aiming for three wins or better in the final 2 weeks to prove they're worthy of an NCAA tournament bid. The Tigers snapped a nine-game losing streak to Alabama with a 78-65 win in Neville Arena back in January. After that loss, Alabama reeled off four straight wins before losing to LSU last Sunday. Players to watch for Auburn, Honesty Scott Grayson has scored at least 20 points in each of the last five games. Taylen Collins is coming off her third double-double of the year. For Alabama, Sarah Ashley Barker leads the Tide, averaging 16 points. Auburn will have their attention set to Jessica Timmons. Timmons led Alabama with a career-high 26 points in the season's first meeting a few weeks ago. Auburn is seeking their first sweep of Alabama since 2019. Pre-game coverage for Auburn women's basketball will begin at 1:45 Central. Tip-off is set for 2 p.m. on AU 100, 100.3 FM, and the Auburn Tigers app. For the Auburn Sports Network, I'm Rib Bowen. War Eagle.
Auburn softball ranked 25th in the country, playing the Puerto Vallarta Challenge down in Mexico, but unable to play the complete schedule. Today's game against Clemson canceled due to field conditions, but an undefeated trip to Mexico for the Tigers. Up next is the Plainsman Invite next weekend. Two games, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. We'll have the coverage on WEGL 91.1 FM and the Auburn Tigers app. You can purchase tickets at AUBTIX.com. Equestrian had a big weekend as well, defeating Dartmouth and number 8 UT Martin. Tigers will be back at home on March 2nd against number 3 SMU at the Auburn University Equestrian Center. That meet is free to attend. Swim and Dive will host the 2024 SEC Championships Monday through Saturday inside the James E. Martin Aquatic Center. 11 a.m. start times Monday and Tuesday, 9:30 a.m. the rest of the week as the Tigers look for some SEC crowns. Number 12 Gymnastics put up a season-high road score at number 3 LSU within 197.1 and will return home on Friday for senior night against number 14, Missouri, at 6 Central. It'll also be the Breast Cancer Awareness Meet, so wear your pink and grab your tickets at AUBTIX.com. This is Auburn's open week upcoming, or open date in the midweek upcoming this week for the Tigers. So no game on Tuesday or Wednesday. The Tigers will be back in action at Georgia on Saturday at 5 o'clock Central, 4:30 airtime with Andy Burcham, Randall Dickey, and Paul Ellen. Tiger Talk will be on Thursday at 6 o'clock. It Baumhauer's Victory Grill. We have to be joined by head coach Bruce Pearl. Always be sure to check out AuburnTigers.com and the Auburn Tigers app for full schedules and more information. That look around Auburn Athletics was brought to you by Auburn Bank, champions of you. Again, your score at the half, Auburn 29, Kentucky 39. We take a look at the first half stats when the Kaneka Sausage Halftime Show continues in a moment.
Kaneka Sausage is a fan favorite for tailgating, always great on the grill, and it's the official sausage dog and hot dog of the Auburn Tigers. Kaneka Sausage is made from the finest cuts of pork, their patented blend of seasonings, and smoked over a pure hickory fire for that true southern flavor. Be sure to visit the Kaneka Gift Shop in Evergreen, Alabama, right off I-65 at exit 96. Enjoy a crowd-pleasing Kaneka Sausage dog while watching the Tigers and make Kaneka part of your game day. Kaneka Sausage, since 1947, a real winner.
Damaging an underground utility can cause a lot more problems than you think. By causing a potentially avoidable damage to underground utilities, there's many scenarios that do not end well. To keep the gas, power, water, and internet running, using 811 to have your underground utilities marked is a critical piece of the damage prevention process, whether you're a homeowner or an excavator. It's free, it's simple, and it's the law. Visit al811.com for more information.
Hi, my name is Alani. A little thing I like about the Spicy Deluxe sandwich is that you taste the crunch, you taste the pepper jack cheese melting, and you taste the spicy flavors in the sandwich. I'm telling you, 10 out of 10.
Hi, my name's Enrique. A little thing I love about Chick-fil-A's Spicy Deluxe sandwich is you get that rich flavor of the chicken and definitely that nice, tangy, warm bite. It's the perfect harmony of spiciness and taste.
Order the Spicy Deluxe sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Real guests paid for their testimonials.
And we're back with the action. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever?
That's right, Jim. With an irresistible taste and zero sugar, Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for any sports fan. So make sure you... Wait, Jim, I didn't mean try it right now. We're still on the air.
Best Coke ever? Take a taste, Jen.
Really?
No, not right now, Jen. We got a game to call.
Left wing, Denver Jones, down to the low post, Broom against Onyesu. Backs his man in, gets double teamed. Spins to the basket, banks it in.
If they let him turn to his right shoulder, he is a dangerous player, and I like the way it happened to Brad Hall.
2-2 the score.
The halftime numbers are brought to you by the Alabama Department of Public Health. Don't wait, vaccinate. Protect yourself and others by staying current on all recommended vaccines. Visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM. Tigers shot 28.1% in the first half, and Kentucky shot 48.3%. Wildcats leading it by 10. The obvious thing to look at, points from turnovers. Kentucky has scored 15 off of turnovers. Auburn has scored zero. The key is going to be stopping the turnovers for the Tigers in the second half. Leading scorer for Auburn, Chad Baker-Mazzara, he scored 7 and grabbed 4 rebounds. The leading rebounder is Jani Broom with 6. Rob Dillingham led Kentucky with the scoring. With 11 points, Nugana Onyenso grabbed 6 rebounds. Those are the halftime stats presented by the Alabama Department of Public Health. And once again, your score at halftime, Auburn 29, Kentucky 39. We will have second half action from Neville Arena as Auburn looks to stay undefeated in the jungle with voice of the Tigers, Andy Burcham, and Hall of Fame coach Sonny Smith after this.
You've been listening to the Koneka Sausage Halftime Show. Make Koneka Sausage part of your game day. Still family-owned and made in Evergreen, Alabama since 1947. The second half is 2 minutes away. This is the Auburn Sports Network.
Four Seasons Federal Credit Union. Homegrown and member-owned.
Four Seasons Federal Credit Union is offering a 7-month CD at an annual percentage yield of 5.64% and a 13-month CD at an annual percentage yield of 5.38%. Four Seasons Federal Credit Union is the financial institution for you. This promotion is for new deposits only with a $2,500 minimum. Membership eligibility required. Accounts are federally insured by the National Credit Union Administration. Contact us for more details.
Fine Dining meets Southern comfort at Vintage 2298, Auburn's newest fine dining restaurant and butcher shop. Chef Randall Baldwin and wife Laura present Gulf cuisine with a Southern flair, made fresh farm to table. Enjoy lunch in the butcher shop, brunch on the weekends at Vintage 2298, where the staff raises the bar on service. Private dining and event space is also available. Experience Vintage 2298 this new year.
Southeastern Industrial Contractors offers the path to a productive and successful career for hard workers of all ages, especially young people looking to jump straight into the workforce. Southeastern Industrial Contractors is now hiring for great-paying, skilled trade positions. Managing partner Derek Harville is a proud Auburn University graduate with deep roots in the community. Give him a call at 334-209-6355 to learn more. Southeastern Industrial Contractors, 334-209-6355.
1907. Auburn had no paved roads, no local newspaper, a few automobiles, very little electricity or indoor plumbing, and one bank, Auburn Bank. For all these years, we've had a part in shaping and serving Auburn, Opelika, and East Alabama, a steadfast partner to our customers, meeting financial needs at just the right times. How do we know our community so well? Because we've grown up together. Auburn Bank, champions of you. Member FDIC, online at auburnbank.com.
Time for the second half. Auburn trails Kentucky 39-29. Auburn will have the arrow. Tigers will have the ball to open second half of play. Auburn's got to do a better job avoiding the turnovers. And Auburn's got to shoot the ball better in the second half too, Sonny.
And they got to defend the lane. That's the only thing that we have not defended the way that we did. But we got to turn them over every once in a while.
Yeah, Kentucky outscored Auburn 20-12 in the paint.
Yeah, we got to do a better job in the paint. That was very evident what they were trying to do. And a lot of that was off the dribble as much as it was a pass.
Every comparative stat points off turnovers in the paint, second chance points, fast break points, and bench points in favor of Kentucky in that first half of play. It should come as no surprise that Kentucky leads by 10 at the half.
I tell you what, Dillingham has got to be stopped. He's the only guy.
Ooh, he's had a good half, hasn't he?
He's the only guy that can go where he wants to against us. Everybody else has pretty much been regulated, but that's
Dillingham. Dillingham, the only player in double figures with 11, and that was off the bench.
I hadn't looked to see the number, but I knew that he was the biggest factor in the first half.
He was indeed. Auburn ball to open the second half. Trey Donaldson, Denver Jones, Chris Moore, Jalen Williams, and Jani Broome. Reeves, Wagner, Edwards, Onyesu, and Fierro for Kentucky.
Andy, we got to get something inside, too. We got to get somebody scoring some baskets inside. Pull that defense in. They're spread out all over the court right now.
Jalen Williams held to just 2 points in the first half. Here's Donaldson, turns the corner on the wing inside the arc. Now backs out with the left hand, 16 to shoot. Brings it out to the top of the circle. He is guarded by DJ Wagner. Good screen from Jalen Williams. Pull up jumper by Donaldson, in and out. Rebound, tap up and missed by Moore. Rebound, Kentucky.
Now they're going to run if they get the ball. We got to get more than one shot in the second half also.
Wagner between the circles gets a screen. Picked up by Denver Jones to the free throw line. Reeves lobs it up there. He didn't get it. Rebound to Kentucky. Onyesu for UK. Into the lane against Broome. He walked and he scores.
He definitely walked, that's for sure. He's about 9 foot tall.
He's
kind of illegal out there.
Kentucky by 12, 41-29, 19:02, second half. Donaldson turns it over. Steal by Wagner against Donaldson. Gets bumped and knocked down, and that's the third foul against Trey Donaldson.
They have been very physical with Trey, and he's trying to get physical back. You can't do it that way.
Another turnover for the Tigers. That is a 7 in the ball game, and
Trey's fouls are certainly.
They're going to look to see if this is a flagrant foul.
Well, it might end up being that, by the way.
They're going to review.
It was a little physical, I will say that.
They are reviewing for whether it's a technical or common foul. I think Trey tried to cut him off, and that's what they're looking at.
He definitely.
There's no question of the foul. I don't deny that.
Yeah. I don't know how this came up to be a factor to start with. What we got to do is keep them out of the lane. And another thing, we got to get into the lane.
Yeah.
We don't want to play this a total perimeter game, and we got to make them not beat us off the dribble.
Great things are possible when you have the power, performance, and smart features of a Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. Greatness starts at your local Ford dealer.
Andy, if you're not at this game, and you're looking at a stat situation, this is a winnable game. We just only got to take care of a couple of things, get ourselves going.
They are going to call this a flagrant foul, apparently.
I thought they might.
So they've called a flagrant 1 on Trey Donaldson.
I thought they might.
So Wagner will shoot 2 free throws and then have the ball out of bounds. And Bruce Pearl would like some kind of explanation. And I'm not so certain he's looking for an explanation on that call, but the fact that Auburn is getting these kind of calls at their end of the floor.
Absolutely.
And Wagner's
true.
Free throw is good.
What happened, Andy? They started letting them play. Now they're trying to reel the game in. Players got to adjust and fit to what the officials are doing. They've changed the way they're calling right now, and they'll get more after this call.
14-point lead for Kentucky, largest lead. Kentucky gets the ball out of bounds. 43-29, 18:56 in the second half. UK has outscored Auburn 4-0 to start the second half of play. UK will trigger baseline right. Broome will guard the inbound pass. Throw ball is deflected. It comes to Onyesu, taken away by Trey Donaldson.
Great defense on the out-of-bounds play. We're good at that.
Donaldson across midcourt. In the center circle, a screen from Broome gets the ball to Janai. Free throw line, back out to the wing for Donaldson. Penetrates inside the arc, spins down the lane to the top. Janai, open for a 3, didn't get it. Rebound Fierro for UK. Up 14, UK
back.
Ball. Left wing, drive, Reeves, and a block. And that's the 4th foul on Trey Donaldson.
Yeah, that's a big time foul right there. That hurts us.
Trey just never could get set. And he commits his 4th foul. And that will bring KD Johnson in, and it will move Denver Jones to the point.
Well, one thing about it, they've worked hard on him, but Dillingham really driving the ball and really getting after him defensively.
Fierro hands to Wagner. Kentucky by 14 with 18:21 in the second half. Wagner drives, kicks it out to the top. Fierro to Wagner in the corner. Working on Broome, 3 ball by Wagner, missed it. Weak side rebound, Onyesu, knocked away by KD Johnson. KD
great
just took
job,
it away from the 7-footer. And he has it left wing, and he pops a 3. Rebound, Broome up, missed it, and he was fouled.
Janai's got to settle down. They're defending him with 2 people. They're pushing and beating on him. He's got to get back to playing Janai basketball, and we'll be in great shape.
Foul is whistled against Antonio Reeves. It is his 3rd. Something to keep an eye on. And Janai is at the line to shoot 2 for Auburn. Auburn right now really struggling from 3 at 3 of 14.
They really are.
Janai's free throw is good.
In the first half, they hurt us in the lane. We had to defend the lane. But now they're shooting the ball up from the outside.
Reeves comes out for Kentucky, and Shepard, who is a spark for UK, back in. He'll run the point. Second free throw by Janai. Good. Twelve-point game. Kentucky full length of the floor to go. Auburn presses. Looking for an inbound. Almost threw it away. Fierro has it at midcourt. Penetrates. Down the lane to the basket. Throws it out to the top for Wagner. 12-point Kentucky lead, 43-31. They've led the entire game. Shot is up. It's missed. Rebound Moore. Auburn the other way. Across midcourt, Denver Jones.
Great defense by Auburn on that last season.
Give and go broom down the floor and a whistle and a foul. Kentucky thought it had a steal by Edwards. And a foul was called, I think, on Edwards. If it is his, it is his third.
Now they've changed the way they're calling. Players have got to adjust, that's for sure. I hope we adjust and Kentucky does.
That is the third foul on Edwards. Auburn out of bounds, baseline left, down 12, 17-38 in the second. Inbound Baker Mazzara. Low post for Williams, and he was fouled by Fierro. Will be the second foul on Adu Fierro, a sophomore out of Pittsburgh.
Kentucky is really banging and holding near the basket and in the lane. We've got to adjust to that, and we got to score points in that lane.
DJ Wagner comes back into the lineup for UK. He replaces Edwards, who has three fouls.
We're good on out-of-bounds plays. We already scored once tonight. We're going to do it again.
Jalen will trigger baseline left. Into the corner, Baker Mazzara. Jones at the top for Broome. Janai to the left wing, Denver. Jalen hands back to Denver. Drives, pull up, 18-footer. Didn't get it. Rebound Shepard for Kentucky. They save it ahead. Wagner, Dillingham at the right wing for Kentucky. Leads Auburn by 12. Shepard left wing, Fierro. Working on Chad Baker Mazzara. Fierro drives to the basket. He lobs it up there. He missed it. Rebound Broome with one hand. Denver Jones the other way. Ahead for Chad Baker Mazzara at the right wing. Down to the baseline. 12-footer in the air. Foul. Dillingham just picked up his third foul.
Well, we had a harder foul out near midcourt if they'd have called it.
It will put Chad Baker Mazzara at the free throw line for two for Auburn.
Yep. Yeah. We got to knock down free throws, and we got to keep them out of the lane.
Chad Baker Mazzara with 7 points. Auburn's second leading scorer behind Janai Broome's 8. Foul against Dillingham, his third. So Dillingham, Edwards, and Reeves for Kentucky with 3. Donaldson on the Auburn bench with 4.
We need dead ball points, and we need points in the lane. We need to keep them out of the lane. Those three things could win this game for us.
Free throw good by Chad Baker Mazzara, the junior from Dominican Republic. A career 86% free throw shooter. Throughout his career, San Diego State here at Auburn.
Janai Broome needs to join the parade and get into the game. We'll be in great shape.
Chad Baker Mazzara trims the lead back to 10. 17 minutes to go. Back to the halftime ball game. 43-33, Kentucky by 10. Fierro hands the ball out to the top. It comes for Wagner. Wagner on the wing, double team. 12 to shoot for Kentucky. Wagner against Chad Baker, penetrates. Cut off, drives, bit it, missed it. Oh, and a whistle and a foul against Auburn.
Oh, no. I started to say a great defensive possession. I didn't realize a foul was being called.
It's going to put Kentucky at the line to shoot a couple.
If you're going to call that, that's one of the easiest fouls committed. You're nuts. You've got to do that on both ends.
Foul whistled against Broome. Free throw is up, and it's good by Wagner. Second foul. Excuse me, first foul on Janai Broome. And he makes both free throws, back up by 12. Boy, Auburn just having to work so hard just to make any kind of run at this point. Kentucky's been able to counter everything that Auburn's thrown at it. And
absolutely. We just got to play our game.
Denver.
They're picking us up awfully high, forcing us to start our defense a little higher than we need to.
Kentucky by 12, 45-33. Left wing, Chad Baker Mazzara. Inside the arc for Jalen Williams, getting bumped by Onyesu. Gets him off the feet, draws the foul. John Calipari can't believe that call. Both of these head coaches have been in the official's ear.
Well,
and I think both of the officials have been right.
Yeah, I think the officials are going to call a little bit more because the first half was, a lot of physicality in the first half.
Well, and we've seen this pattern all season long, Sonny.
Yes.
They let them go in the first half, and I'm not saying it intentional, and then it's a much closer called game in the second.
Well, if you let two teams go, they're going to get real physical. And maybe they're trying to get the game under control now.
Jalen's free throw is good. Cuts the lead to 11, 16-14 in the second half.
Dead ball points wins games.
Second free throw, in and out. Kentucky by 11, 16-10, second half of play. UK ball, Fierro to Wagner, off the right wing, Shepard. Brings it top of the circle, backs it up. Off the right side for Justin Edwards. Picked up by Denver Jones aggressively. Edwards, off the right side, Wagner. Wagner, outside the arc, 7 to shoot. Wagner against Denver Jones. Free throw line, Wagner. Backdoor pass, ball stripped away. Here's Auburn the other way. Baker Mazar ahead for KD Johnson. Drives to the hole, he scores!
And he got fouled, didn't he?
One of the few times Auburn beat UK down the floor.
Man, we did it. We did it after a steal.
45-36. Yeah, that's Auburn's first bucket after a turnover tonight.
Yeah.
Shepard works on Baker Mazar. John Calipari on the floor right now. Ball knocked away by Baker Mazar. Shepard retrieves. 9 to shoot. Free throw line. Put it up. He didn't get it. Rebound Chad Baker. Ball loose. Still loose. Shepard runs it down for UK. Ball deflected again to the wing. Edwards knocks down KD, loses the ball. Still loose. Kentucky gets a dunk.
Woo! I've seen fights that wasn't this bad.
Fierro, whistle foul.
They got to get him back on his.
Now, they will warn John Calipari, who was almost at midcourt.
He was beyond it, actually. No, he wasn't.
A warning has been given to Calipari, and we've got a timeout. 14:54 to go in the second half. Kentucky 47, Auburn 36. Stay tuned. Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
Now this game
is... For me, basketball season is a grind. That's why it's great to get away and recharge in my Ford F-150 truck. With available Pro Power on board, which lets me use F-150 as a mobile generator, I can enjoy the great outdoors while watching games and highlights on my flat-screen TV. Ah, relaxation. Check out the official truck of the Auburn Tigers at your local Ford dealer and tell them Bruce Pearl sent you. See owner's manual for important operating instructions. Some models, trims, and features may not be available and may be subject to change.
Let's face it, nothing makes you look older than you really are than thinning hair. But what if you could not only increase your hair count, but promote new hair growth without surgery, without drugs with potential side effects, and without a prescription from your doctor? Well, now you can. Thanks to a breakthrough new supplement called Hair Grow, provided by New Nordic, the number one supplier of dietary supplements in Europe. Hair Grow is now available in the U.S. Only Hair Grow contains Tokogaya, a powerful antioxidant that has received a U.S. patent. Multiple clinical studies show Hair Grow is safe and effective in promoting new hair growth. In one study, 95% of the patients using Hair Grow saw increased hair count. Don't lose more time and more hair. Try Hair Grow today to feel and look your best. Just go to newnordicusa.com or visit Walgreens or Amazon to purchase. Look younger and feel more confident with Hair Grow by New Nordic at newnordicusa.com.
Alabama Power is proud to present this broadcast of Auburn basketball. Alabama Power, power for a better Alabama.
14:54 to go in the second half. Auburn trails 47-36 to Kentucky. Auburn has been as close as 9 in the second half. Kentucky has led by as much as 14 in the second half of play.
I put down on the paper that we got to stop Dillingham. Well, we got not only stop Dillingham, we got to stop the other guards too. Their guards are creating a lot of problems for us.
Here's another thing that Auburn's got to get better at, that's shooting the basketball. The Tigers are 1 of 5 from the field in the second half. What has helped Auburn is that Auburn is 5 of 6 from the free throw line. But boy, Auburn's got to find the half court offense right now or the transition game.
They're putting great pressure on the basketball. Yeah. And they're really working on our post people by banging them, fronting them, and we got to get somebody else started offensively.
Kentucky has outscored Auburn off of turnovers 17-2. Points in the paint 24-14.
Oh, that's been big, I think.
Second chance points 14-8. Fast break points 11-7. And Auburn's bench has outscored Kentucky 17-15. It's not hard to see why Kentucky leads by 11 right now.
Yeah, and you would think with those kind of stats it'd be ahead by more, which means that we're doing some things right.
Rebounding right now, Kentucky 26, Auburn 25. On the Outlive Day, you can still make donations, by the way, to Outlive. It does not end today. Go to Outlive, A-U-T-L-I-V-E, Outlive.com, Outlive.com. You can purchase more of the Outlive t-shirts and make donations to the Outlive Foundation. For Auburn, Jalen Williams, Chad Bakemazar, Aiden Holloway, Katie Johnson, and Janai Broom. That's the Auburn five. For Kentucky, Edwards, Onyesu, Shepard, Wagner, and Fierro, and they will press Auburn.
It's not our defense that's beating us. The fact that we're not scoring the ball. Yep. We're not scoring the ball in any situation.
Auburn
and
down.
That could be their defense.
Excuse me, Sonny. Auburn down 11 with 14:54 in the second half.
Right now, they're pressing full court for a change.
Inbound to Holloway. He will be hawked by DJ Wagner up the floor. Aiden across midcourt with 21 to shoot. Holloway against Wagner. Out to the top, Broom, right wing, Chad Baker-Mazzara. Goes baseline, hang, shoots, scores.
Well, they're not letting anybody on our team to post up. They're double teaming or playing front, playing behind. Got to have a stop.
His first two-point basket of the game. Shepard ahead, Fierro behind the defense, stripped by Jaden Williams. And then Fierro lost it out of bounds.
No foul.
Fierro got behind Jalen, who recovered and knocked the ball off of Fierro out of bounds. Right. Auburn down 9 with the ball, 14-19, second half.
Effort's not our problem.
No.
Got to get the ball in the bucket, get it in the middle of the lane.
Holloway, bounce pass, Chad Baker-Mazzara. Free throw line, left wing, KD, three ball, KD didn't get it. Wagner gets the rebound for UK.
Got a good shot.
Auburn, 3 of 14 from 3 today. 47-38. Wagner to the wing, to the top, steal, KD Johnson against Shepard, and he scores.
What a great steal, Duncan. He's very good at that. He's a momentum guy.
Down to a 7-point game. Listen to the ground. Shepard, midcourt, working on KD. Shepard. Fierro outside the arc left side. Hands to Will Edwards. Drives, knocks down. Yep, charge. Edwards well, knocked down Chad Baker-Mazzara.
That was a great call.
And that's his fourth. That's four fouls on Edwards.
Great defense. Couple of steals, got the crowd in the game. We got to take advantage of that.
Chaney Johnson in for Auburn. Jalen Williams is out. Tigers down 7, 13, 23 in the second. Aiden Holloway will bring it up the floor. He'll be greeted just beyond midcourt by Rob Dillingham. Holloway, KD Johnson, working on Shepard, drives to the hole, shoots, missed it. Rebound, Broom, good.
Gotta get back.
5-point game, 47-42 UK.
KD got a score.
13 minutes in the second. Dillingham tried to turn the corner. Drives into the lane. Picks it on the wing. Reeves drives to the hole. He missed it. Got his own rebound. It's blocked. Rebound on the floor. Auburn out of there. Here comes Holloway. Down 5, Auburn ball. KD off the left side. Chaney, open three. No.
Get back.
Here's Shepard the other way for Kentucky. 47-42 UK, timeout Kentucky.
We're back in the game. We're doing it with defense.
Second half tonight presented by Wind Creek Hotel and Casino. With three Alabama locations in Atmore, Montgomery, and Wetumpka, you escape every day at Wind Creek Hotel and Casino and online at windcreek.com. 12:31 in the second. Kentucky 47, Auburn 42. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly.
Live Sports Radio, bringing you inside Neville Arena for all the action of men's and women's basketball game day with no delay. Every dunk, block shot, and steal, plus all the analysis from our Hall of Fame coaches, all with no delay. $25 new or $10 to reprogram the one you already have. Also, use it for every broadcast of home baseball and softball games this spring, all with no delay. With Live Sports Radio, presented by Alpha Insurance.
Who says you need snow to live in a winter wonderland? Southerners know a true winter smells like pine, cinnamon, and citrus. And the only warmth you need is delivered by time with friends and family. Farm fresh sweet potatoes, Christmas trees, and satsumas just make this time of the year even sweeter. Whether you're preparing to jingle some bells or settle into a silent night by a roaring fire, Sweet Grown Alabama has something for you. Find sweet potatoes, Christmas trees, satsumas, and more near you at sweetgrownalabama.org.
The game has changed, and the future of Auburn athletics now demands a strong NIL program. I'm Jason Campbell. Let's come together, Auburn family, and make a lasting impact. Visit ontovictory.com. Every dollar you contribute to On to Victory helps create NIL opportunities for our student athletes. Visit www.ontovictory.com and be a part of changing the game for Auburn athletics.
Welcome back to Neville Arena courtside as Auburn has gone on a 6-0 run to cut the deficit to 5 against the Wildcats. Jacob Hillman here with a check to the Yellowwood scoreboard. Number 8, Tennessee has defeated Vanderbilt 88-53 at Thompson Bowling Arena behind Josiah Jordan James, 13.7 rebounds and 3 steals. Looking at some top 25 action, number 14 Illinois is at Maryland and trails by 1, 75-74, with 20 seconds left in that ballgame. Jameer Young leads the Terrapins with 26 points. Marcus Dobask has 19-12 for the Fighting Illini. Number 12 Baylor is pulling away from West Virginia, leading 79-63 with 5:59 to go in that ballgame. That's a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard. Back to the voice of the Tigers, Andy Burcham, and Hall of Fame coach, Sonny Smith.
6-0 run of the last 2 minutes and 5 seconds by Auburn. Chad Bacon-Mazar with 11 points, Sonny, according to Auburn's media relations director for basketball, Marlene DeVore. That's his fifth double-figure game in the last six for Chad Bacon-Mazar.
Well, what they're doing right now, early in the first half, they try to take away everything in the paint. Now, other people are getting the ball into the paint scoring. Our perimeter people are scoring points. We keep that up. They're going to have to extend their defense to guard those people, and then we can throw it inside to Bruce.
Katie Johnson with a nice surge, whatever you want to call it here in the second half with 4 points.
Defensive, too. He's really been all over his man.
Kentucky ball leading Auburn by 5, 47-42. Cats led by as many as 14.
The physicality of Kentucky is backed off because of the officials. We've got to take advantage of that right now.
Out of bounds down the left sideline. Shepherd will trigger. 24 in the shot clock for UK. To Dillingham, back to Shepherd, picked up by Aiden Holloway. Through the center circle, bounce pass Dillingham. At the top of the key, baseball pass right back to Shepherd, 13 to shoot. Reeves, top of the circle, guarded by CBM. Gets a screen from Onyesu. Double team to Onyesu. Back to Reeves. 5 to shoot. Drives to the hole. He got it.
Oh, my goodness. We were defending so well, but we got extended with our defense and left the lane open, and they drove on us.
7-point lead for Kentucky, 49-42. Holloway, right side of the circle, Cardwell. To Aiden. Drives past Dullingham to the hole. He scores.
Well, he can get around him because they're trying to force him from one side to the other, leaving the dribble not unprotected.
First bucket of the night for Aiden Holloway. Trims the lead back to 5. Shepherd, Dillingham, picked up by Holloway at the point. 17 to shoot, UK. There's a screen. He's double-teamed. To Onyesu at the top.
Back to Dillingham. Turns the corner, drives, and loses it out of bounds. To Auburn.
That was a great defensive stand. We're getting great help by our perimeter, on the perimeter with our big people.
When we come back, Auburn ball down 5, 11:29 in the second. Kentucky 49, Auburn 44. Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
It's the classic dilemma at Whataburger. You pick up your all-time favorite patty melt with two fresh all-beef patties, melted Monterey Jack cheese, grilled onions, and creamy pepper sauce. And just when you're about to dig in to Whataburger's take on this delicious all-time classic, someone utters the dreaded words.
Can I have a bite?
Should you? Shouldn't you? Maybe you should just take a big bite so you don't have to answer. Ooh, glad that dilemma's over. The Whataburger patty melt, just like you like it.
This is the moment you've been waiting for.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our home.
When you step onto the court and into the spotlight, the moment to show that hard work and long days pay off. Because when that final shot leaves your hands and we leave our seats, that powerful moment connects us all.
Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Power for a better Alabama.
Southern homes are particularly vulnerable to termites. In this climate, you need guaranteed protection. You need Cook's Pest Control and Centricon. Termites attack the Centricon stations, exposing themselves to an agent that eliminates their entire colony. Upgrade from old-fashioned liquid service to the proven protection of Centricon and Cook's Pest Control. Call Cook's today for a free evaluation.
Looky, 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 here comes Cookie, Cook's Pest Control.
A look at the defensive statistics is brought to you by Cook's Pest Control and Centricon. You don't have to live with termites.
Auburn trails by 5, 49-44. Before we get to that defensive stat, the big hurt Frank Thomas, tonight's celebrity in. And here's one thing that's turned a little bit, Sonny Smith. Kentucky now has 10 turnovers in the game.
Yes.
And 6 of those have come in the second half. Points off turnovers, still Kentucky with the edge, 70-6, but those turnovers are resulting in empty possessions,
empty possessions
for Kentucky.
Exactly. I thought this was going to happen. I thought we could keep them out of the lane, turn them over a little bit, and get something going offensively. We're still not going to play great offensively.
But shooting better at 42% in the second half, it still feels like you're pulling teeth.
Usually we get into the paint, make things happen. Yeah. They're keeping us out, doing a pretty good job on that.
Here's another thing that we're used to, watching this Auburn offense just go on these deep runs. That hasn't been the case today. No. Auburn's going to have to win it by being a dentist, just pulling teeth down the stretch of this one.
They really have to. If we can get into the paint a little bit on a dribble, and they're in a little bit of foul trouble like we're in a little bit of foul trouble.
Right, you're right.
So we ought to be able to do that.
Yeah, that's a good point, Sonny. Justin Edwards has 4 fouls. Reeves and Dillingham have 3. For Auburn, Trey Donaldson with 4.
Yeah.
Katie Johnson with 3. Katie picked 3 of those up in the first half.
Well, both teams' perimeter play has been the big thing, and trying to stop each other. And if we can stay out of foul trouble and just defend that lane, not let them get in on the dribble, I think we're going to be in good shape. All we got to do is make it basket.
11:29 to go in the second half. Auburn trails by 5. Auburn ball. And Auburn basketball is brought to you by Auburn Opelika Tourism. Start your next visit to the Plains at aotourism.com. For Kentucky, Dillingham, Shepherd, Fierro, Reeves, and Onyesu. For Auburn, Chad Makeup is on. Jalen Williams, Katie Johnson, Aiden Holloway, and at the other end, Dylan Cardwell. Tigers down 5. This is as close as Auburn has been since the first half.
We're right in this thing, and we're not making anything from the outside. Should we start doing that, I think Kentucky's going to be in trouble.
Bounce pass, Holloway will bring it up the floor against Shepherd.
Kentucky putting real pressure on full court.
Holloway across midcourt. Tigers down 5 with the ball. Aiden off the left wing. KD, low post, Jalen off of his hand. And here's Kentucky the other way. Dillingham down to the post. Reeves, reverse layup, good.
Yeah,
boy, you just
He just tried to score before he caught it. They're worrying about the block shot. You can't do that.
7-point lead for Kentucky, 51-44. Holloway works on to Shepherd. Reaches in, gets it to Chad Baker-Mazzara near the left corner. Double team, loops a pass. Jalen Holloway, free throw line, down the lane. Back door, Jalen, left-hand hammer, he missed it. He goes down hard. He's hurt. His knee is hurt. Kentucky the other way, and now they're going to stop play. Oh, dear goodness.
I hope that's...
Oh, my.
You could tell that
it's,
was a knee,
it's
though.
The right knee of Jalen Williams. And Clark Pearson, Auburn's athletic trainer, and team doctor Michael Goodlett are out.
ID.
Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the Auburn Sports Network from PlayPlug. Well, Jalen Williams has rolled over on his back. They continue to look at his right knee. He went up for a dunk.
You
came
see.
Down hard and stayed down.
Yeah. Came down awkwardly.
Then. Yeah.
I think he did something to his knee. I don't know how bad. Hope not bad.
My goodness.
Well, we still got this game to play, and we've got the thing in a little bit better situation than we had it before. We got them missing, but we got to start making something on the other end.
A lot of folks very quiet right now. Jalen sits up.
Yeah, the crowd is.
Oh, boy. Oh, my.
Must well, be more than we thought.
He will get up. He will take some help. He does not put any pressure or any weight on that right leg, and I think Auburn will take him off the floor.
Yeah, they'll take
Damon Davis, Auburn strength and conditioning coach and athletic trainer Clark Pearson, take him off the floor. Oh my, 10:40 to go in the second half. Kentucky by 7, 51-44.
That's a bad break. Somebody's got to make up for the way that he's been playing for us.
Kentucky basketball,
basketball
at its end of the floor.
The sideline.
Yeah, 25 to shoot for Kentucky. Chaney Johnson in for the injured Jalen Williams.
Chaney's got to become a big-time defender right now because Jalen's been playing really good.
Apparently Chaney had not checked in. He now does. Shepherd, the inbound Reeves. To Shepherd. Kentucky by 7, 51-44. 18 to shoot. Bounce pass, Dillingham at the top. Left wing, Reeves. Top of the circle, Shepherd. 10 to shoot for Kentucky. Reeves at the right wing. Gets a screen. Dillingham drives to the hole. Block
good
and a foul
block
on Chaney Johnson.
Oh, no. Call a foul.
That they did. It was on Chaney. It'll be his second. And it will put Dillingham at the line for two. Excuse me. It's the arrow that goes to the line for two for Kentucky. 77% free throw shooter. First free throw is good.
Now we got to play defense without fouling. We got to keep them off the line because our defense is picked up. We're keeping them out of the lane on the dribble.
He can take the lead to 9, and he does.
All right, get a good look.
Auburn had the lead down to 5 and had the ball. Tigers have given up 4 straight points since then. Auburn's in desperate need of a bucket right here. Cardwell, Holloway, looked at a long three. Off the right side, curl. Baker-Mazzara underneath for Cardwell, and he's fouled by Onyesu.
That was a well-designed, well-ran play. Just didn't put it down.
Onyesu whistled for his 3rd foul. And Dillon goes to the line to shoot 2 for Auburn. 4 points in the first half for Cap Cardwell.
We got to make some points with the clock dead, and we got to keep them off the foul line and keep them out of the lane.
First free throw, in and out.
You know, he shoots with no arc. It's got to be perfect or it's not going to go down.
Auburn 13 of 19 from the charity stripe tonight, 5 of 7 in the second half.
And I thought that first one was going to go down.
Second free throw, missed both. Rebound to Onyesu, outlet for Kentucky. They can take the lead into double figures. Shepherd across midcourt against Chad Baker-Mazzara. 53-44 Kentucky, 9:49 in the second. whistle, and Dillingham just ran through Chad Bacon Mazar at the free throw line. And that will be the fourth foul on Rob Dillingham. That's a break for Auburn.
Absolutely great defense. Absolutely great defense.
And as a result, DJ Wagner back into the lineup, replacing Dillingham, who's been a terrific spark for UK off the bench with the 11 points and 2 rebounds and 3 assists.
All right, we got to get something. It's time to make them work a little bit on defense.
9:41 in the second. Tigers down 9 with the ball. KD Johnson drives to the hole, hangs, shoots, scores.
He can do it.
He just beat Shepard.
He
beat Shepard to the hole, didn't he? 8 for KD. All in the second half, back to a 7-point game. UK ball. Wagner against KD Johnson. Bounce pass. Reeves against Chad Bacon Mazar. Shepard picked up by Holloway. Left-hand dribble, Shepard at the top. Reeves on a curl in the lane to the hole. He put it up, and he scores with a foul.
He curled. They set a little screen for him under the basket. He curled off that screen and got an opening. We got to chunk him. They chunk us pretty hard when we run that same kind of play.
Foul against Janai Broome, his second. An opportunity for the 3-point play for Reeves to take the lead to 10. Every time Kentucky's had an answer tonight.
Janai's got to pick it up a little bit. He could really turn.
Reeves missed it. Rebound out of there comes to Auburn. Auburn with a break there. That guy shoots 88% from the line. Tigers down 9. 9:01 in the second half. Holloway. Crossover. Got a screen. 3 ball. Aiden. No. Rebound. Chaney Johnson to the floor. Jump ball. Kentucky has the arrow. Chaney hit the ground hard. And Fierro hit it even harder for UK. Both. Auburn 3-point shooting tonight, 3 of 17.
No, we haven't done that. And it's not so much on, it's not so much because of we're not making them. They were defending it really well. They were taking us out of the lane and defending the three.
Kentucky by 9 with the ball, 8:50 to go, second half. Waiting on any kind of word about Jalen Williams from the Auburn locker room. Between the circles, Shepard. Reed, left wing Reeves, open 3 ball, got it.
Oh, that's
huge. That's an enormous basket for Kentucky, up by 12.
Did not get out on him like we're supposed to.
Nope, they got a screen on the low post, and he was wide open on the left wing for the 3 ball. Kentucky by 12, 58-46. Holloway, left wing, drive to the hole, into the corner, Janai for 3. Nope, weak side rebound. Auburn, KD up, missed it. Rebound Kentucky. Woo. Auburn shooting just not there tonight.
Can't
for
throw
the Tigers.
It in the ocean right now.
Auburn, 3 of 18 from 3 tonight. Shooting 30% from the field overall. Kentucky by 12 with the ball, under 8 minutes to go. Shepard, left wing, Reeves, another 3. Didn't get this one, rebound weak side Edwards. Auburn didn't box out on the weak side.
Got a box out, we did not box.
Kentucky ball, Shepard at the top.
They're going to drain the clock every time they can.
Reeves, Wagner at the top, 7 to shoot. Kentucky by 12 with the ball. 7.5 minutes to go. Wagner slips, goes underneath.
Whoa.
And no whistle. Nope, they got a whistle and a foul against Auburn.
Well, we fouled, but it was after the walk.
Time out of the floor. Kentucky at the free throw line when we come back. 7.5 minutes to go. Kentucky 58, Auburn 46. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly.
Hi, my name is Alani. A little thing I like about the spicy deluxe sandwich is that you taste the crunch, you taste the pepper jack cheese melting, and you taste the spicy flavors in the sandwich. I'm telling you, 10 out of 10.
Hi, my name's Enrique. A little thing I love about Chick-fil-A's Spicy Deluxe sandwich is you get that rich flavor of the chicken and definitely that nice, tangy, warm bite. It's the perfect harmony of spiciness and taste.
Order the Spicy Deluxe sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Real guests paid for their testimonials.
And we're back with the action. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever.
That's right, Jim. With an irresistible taste and zero sugar, Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for... Aw, Jim.
Best Coke ever? Take a taste, Jen.
We're still on the air.
Hello, this is Coach Hugh Freeze. They say Coke Zero Sugar is irresistibly tasty. Does that make it the best Coke ever? Find out for yourself. War Eagle.
We always picture the SEC student athlete for their speed, their vertical, their agility. but it's time we picture them for more. For their campus voice, their community outreach, and for the simple fact that 20 years later, they're still someone's pride and joy. More than students, more than athletes, in the SEC, it just means more.
Welcome back to Neville Arena. Jacob Hillman here. The check of the Yellowwood scoreboard. They've gone final at Maryland in the Xfinity Center in College Park. Number 14, Illinois, able to pull out an 85-80 win over the Terrapins. Marcus Domas had a big game for the Illini, a 19-point, 12-rebound double-double. West Virginia's trying to climb back in the game with Baylor, but with just over 70 seconds left, the Bears are probably going to pull this one out with an 11-point lead in Morgantown. Number 23, Indiana State leads Southern Illinois 42-38 with 15:51 to go in that ball game. And that's a check of the Yellowwood scoreboard. We'll have a full check of the Yellowwood scoreboard during the Regents Bank postgame show. Back to Andy and Sonny.
We have received no word on the health of Jalen Williams, who went down on an attempted dunk, injured his, it appeared, his right knee and was helped off the floor going to the Auburn locker. We may not get an update on Jalen's condition before this one's out. In all likelihood, Auburn's going to have to try and find a way to come back from 12 down in the last 7.5 minutes without one of its best players. Right now, the Tigers really struggling from the field. 15 of 49 on the night at 30.6%. Only 3 of 18 from the three-point stripe. Kentucky only has 4 threes tonight, but the Wildcats have 5 more two-point baskets than does Auburn tonight.
Well, they've kept us out of the lane on the drive and in the pass in the post to score. We have not kept them out of the lane on the drive.
Jani Broome, a rebound away from a double-double. He has 10 points and 9 rebounds. Chad Baker Mazzara with his 5th double-digit scoring game in his last 6 games. He has 11 points and 5 rebounds. Donaldson with 4 fouls is back in. He joins Denver Jones, Chris Moore, Jani Broome, and Chaney Johnson.
Jani's got to become a factor so we can make him defend that post so we can get a little bit of opening on the perimeter.
Free throw by Wagner is good. His 5th free throw of the night, and all 5 of his charity tosses have come in the second half. He makes both.
And now they'll pick up, but not full court.
14-point lead again for Kentucky. Boy, if Auburn's going to come back, they've got to do it right now, friends. Chaney Johnson at the point, left wing Denver. Low post for Jani against Onyesu. Turns and scores.
We got to get him going, and they did exactly what they needed to do. Go to the post.
12 points for Broome. 60-48, Kentucky, 7:07. A low-scoring game for both of these squads tonight. Kentucky will try to use the clock. Oh. Reeves, Wagner, Reeves at the point. Wagner on the wing to Reeves, drives down to the baseline, lobs it up, and he scores, and Auburn cannot stop Antonio Reeves.
He is so quick.
He is killing Auburn right now. He is the leading scorer of the game with 18 points. 7 of 14 from the field. Kentucky by 14. Auburn cannot trade baskets now, friends. Broome, double team, throws it away. Shepherd took it away. Kentucky by 14, the basketball, 6:27 to go. Between the circles, Wagner. Bounce pass, Reeves. Out the top for Shepherd. 13 to shoot, Reeves. One-on-one against Chaney Johnson. Drives on Chaney to the hole. He didn't get it. Onyesu goes over the back of Broome and a bucket underneath. Reeves put it in. Onyesu was on the back of Jani Broome, and it was not called.
It was a foul on Kentucky, without a doubt.
Kentucky leads it by 16, 64-48. Three ball missed by Denver Jones. Rebounded underneath by Kentucky.
Got to get back.
5:43 to go.
Kentucky's going to bleed the clock now.
And they're scoring every time down the floor right now. Auburn's not getting stops. Kentucky ball in the corner. Reeves for 3. Didn't get it. Rebound Chaney Johnson. Push. That's going to go against Kentucky.
Well, that was a correct call.
Chad Baker-Lazar back in, replacing Moore. Stops the clock with 5:31 to go. That's the fifth foul on the night for Justin Edwards. Of little consequence, I'm afraid, however. Kentucky leads Auburn by 16, 64-48.
We have not been able to score the ball on open shots. Yeah. We haven't been able to get open. And a lot of that's got to go to Kentucky not being able to get open. But our ball movement has not been what it normally is.
Kentucky's come in and played its game tonight. It's a little bit different than what we thought, but Kentucky's outplayed Auburn. I hate to say that, but that's the case, friends. And the fact that it's happened here perhaps is the biggest surprise of all.
Yeah. We knew they would be physical, but I didn't think they would be able to move the ball around the perimeter the way. Their defense has not been physical enough with them, maybe.
Chaney Johnson at the line for Auburn. A one in bonus, and he missed it. Rebound, Broom had it, lost it. It comes to Denver Jones. Denver out to the top for Donaldson. Long three, Trey. Nope, rebound, Shepard.
We're shooting desperation shots now.
Auburn, 3 of 20 from 3. 64-48 Kentucky. Reeves to Shepard at the top. 5:07 in the second half. Drive by Reeves, right side of the lane, top of the circle, Shepard, 7 to shoot for UK. Reeves backs it up. Drives on Chad Baker-Mazar to the hole, fade away. He didn't get it. Rebound, Broom has a double-double.
Got to run.
64-48, 4:49 to go. Right wing, Chad Baker-Mazar. Three ball corner, no, but he's fouled by Shepard, who said that Chad Baker-Mazar kicked out. It will put CBM at the line for three for Auburn.
We got to get a combination of stops and baskets quick on the run and some perimeter shooting.
Kentucky's entire bench of coaches is up. So they've gotten their second bench warning. And Chad Baker-Mazar goes to the line to shoot three for Auburn. Chad with 11 points and 5 rebounds.
John is not going to let up on the officials on that call.
Chad Baker-Mazar.
Get in there.
He rattles it home.
Now we're gonna have to go with some full court pressure, and we're gonna have to come up with some steals. Because we can't be putting them on a foul line. We just need to make the steals without fouling. Defense without fouling is a big factor.
Chad gets the second to roll in. Donaldson out, Katie Johnson in, so Denver Jones will take over at the point. Free throw by Chad, it fell. It almost came out. Kentucky by 13, 64-51, 4:38, second half. Shepard backs it up, shot clock at 18. The arrow at the point. To Reeves on the wing, left side. They clear it out with 10 to shoot. Right wing, Fierro drives on Broom, puts it up, Janai blocked it. Rebounded by KD on the break. KD, free throw line, down the lane to the hole. No, but he goes down hard. No foul there. Rebound, Kentucky.
Now they're going to milk the clock. We've got to put great pressure on them, make them get rid of the ball and get a steal or two.
4:03 in the second. Kentucky by 13 points. 64-51, Reeves. Shepard backs it up. 10 to shoot for Kentucky. Shepard drives through the lane, in the lane, kicks it to Reeves driving. Running one-hander, he didn't get it. Rebound out of there for Auburn. Katie Johnson, Denver Jones up the floor. Down 13, Auburn ball. Denver on the left wing. 3:38 and counting. Broom against Onyesu. Head fake. Out to the top. Denver a three straight away. Yes!
Got to press him.
Cuts the lead to 10. 3:25. 64-54. Shepard. Reeves. Excuse me, Wagner. Two Reeves. On the right wing, double team there. Reeves.
Walt.
Double team.
Walt.
Whistle foul.
Timeout called by Kentucky.
They we definitely fouled him, but he walked before that. They're not calling the walks in a double up.
22nd timeout.
It's a timeout on the floor, 3:10 to go. Kentucky 64, Auburn 54. Kentucky ball when we come back. Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
Vizzy's vibrant dual flavors. The vibe is yours to decide.
I'm thinking Vizzy Refreshingly Berry. A round of blackberry lemon at the bar?
Could be good. Maybe Vizzy Vibrantly Tropical.
You always say Vibrantly Tropical.
Come on, a cooler full of papaya passion fruit on the beach?
Oh yeah, that's a vibe. I'm down.
Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Naturally flavored with other natural flavors. Celebrate responsibly. 2023 Molson Coors Beverage Company. Milwaukee, Wisconsin flavored beer.
War Eagle, it's a great day for Auburn Tigers to get vaccinated. Many children and adults that delayed vaccinations during the pandemic are still behind schedule. It's crucial that we take steps to get everyone back on track with their routine immunizations. Children and teens can still catch up on their vaccinations even if they start late. Make sure you and your family are all up to date on all recommended vaccines, including COVID-19 and flu. Let's all do our part to get back on track. Don't wait. Vaccinate. For more information, visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM.
Today's highlight is brought to you by Toyota. At home or on the road, they're never the underdog. Toyota. Let's go places. Lease a new 2024 Toyota RAV4 LE for $329 a month for 39 months. Offer valid through March 4, 2024. Well-qualified lessees with approved credit through Southeast Toyota Finance. 3628 due at signing. No security deposit with select equipment. $350 disposition fee. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and dealer fees. See dealer for details.
Keep it here after the game for the Regions Bank postgame show with final stats and analysis, plus comments from Coach Pearl.
3:10 to go in the second half. Kentucky 64, Auburn 54. Kentucky ball coming out of the timeout. And for every Auburn three-pointer, Berkshire Hathaway Home Services donates $25 to Coach Pearl's Outlive Cancer Initiative, benefiting local cancer patients and treatment centers. Four threes for Auburn tonight, Sonny.
The points they have scored off our turnovers has been big. They've been able to take those turnovers and turn them into points, but we have not been able to turn them over enough to get points so far.
21-8, that advantage for Kentucky. Points in the second chance points, 18-10. Fast break points, 13-9. Points in the paint, 32-26. Just about every comparative stat, Kentucky is leading tonight, Sonny.
Exactly right.
53rd consecutive sellout at Neville Arena. Auburn's going to have to pull off one heck of a comeback to keep its win streak alive tonight. 15 straight coming in. Well, and Ibrahim's double-double is the 56th of his outstanding career.
We haven't quit. We just can't make shots. And do you give Kentucky credit on that? To a certain degree, you do. We missed a lot of open shots. And in the paint, we have not been able to get it inside, hurt them to where they can get in foul trouble.
And Antonio Reeves down the stretch of this game has made big shot after big shot.
Yes,
when Kentucky's out there running clock. He has 22 points to lead all scores. He's 8 of 19 from the field, 3 of 6 from 3. He has 3 of the 4 made threes tonight for UK.
Well, we're going to have to run with the ball. We're going to have to put it up quick, but we don't want to bad shoot ourselves out of the game either.
Kentucky out of bounds, baseline right, or excuse me, down the right sideline. They'll be shooting free throws on Auburn's next foul. Shepherd will trigger into the backcourt for Wagner. 3:07 in the second half, 6 on the shot clock for Kentucky. Wagner against KD in the lane, stripped. And there's a steal and a whistle and a foul. It's going to go against Wagner. Hey, that puts Auburn at the line for two with 2:59 to go. It stops the clock, and Auburn can go to the free throw line and shoot two shots.
When he lost the ball, he grabbed the guy that knocked it out of his hand, and that was a really good call. I wouldn't think they would make that.
He grabbed Janai, who's at the line for two right now. 2:59 to go, an opportunity to score with the clock stopped. Free throw, Janai. Yes.
Dead ball points make all the difference. Got to have them.
Well, they do when you're trying to come back. That's for certain. Second free throw. 8-point game.
We will press, and we will press the steal. Got to watch them throwing long.
64-56, Kentucky. 2:59 in the second. UK ball full length on the floor to go. Shepherd will trigger. He'll be face guarded by Cheney Johnson.
They'll try to get it to Dillingham.
He lobs it for Onyesu. Back to Shepherd. Under 3 minutes to go. Kentucky by 8.
Defense without foul.
Got to get a stop. Just have to get a stop, friends. They have Dillingham working on Chad Baker Mazar. Shot clock at 15. Now Reeves. Shepherd at the top. Working clock. It's down to 9. Underneath, Fierro dunks it on a great pass from Shepherd.
We were running and create a double up, yeah. Left the post wide open. That was bad defense right there.
Kentucky by 10. Big play by Shepherd to Fierro. 2:24 to go. Denver Jones drives to the hole. Hangs goes up and missed it. And he'll go to the line for 2.
Well, they're extending our defense. Their defense, we can get into the lane on the drive. We just got to make something happen.
Auburn lost Jalen Williams here in the second half of play with an injured knee. That's all we know at this point. As he went to the Auburn locker room, we have not received any word other than to confirm it is a knee injury for Auburn's fifth-year senior from Nahunta, Georgia.
Conversation going on right now about something that happened on the court, and they're going to look it over. I didn't see anything out of the way.
There is a review on the foul by Antonio Reeves, his fourth of the night. Auburn is at the line with 2:21 to go, down 10, 66-56. Every time Auburn's made a run, and Auburn has been able to get within 5 in the second half and had the ball at that point, but did nothing with it. And Kentucky then has taken the lead out. It's hovered around 10 for the rest of this half. And, of course, in that mix is Auburn losing its second leading scorer, Jalen Williams, to the injured knee.
When Kentucky gets the ball across midcourt, they're going to take time off on the clock because they've done that the whole game. You know, they don't come in
well, I'll tell you what. They're looking to see if Denver Jones was hit in the face on his drive to the basket.
Well, people have been hit.
Excuse me, it was Martin Mazzara. I apologize. Chad Baker Mazzara.
They must have thought yes.
Well, that would give Auburn 2 free throws and the ball.
I think that's what happened.
With 2:21 to go. And it is Denver Jones going to the line.
The way coach is going after it must not have worked the way we thought. It was like an intentional elbow.
They are not going to call it a flagrant foul. Denver Mike got hit in the face.
He did. I don't know
and
how
boy,
hard.
And Bruce Pearl is really illustrating that right now to Joe Lindsay. Boy, and now he's talking with all three of the officials right now. Denver at the line, the first of 2, missed.
Well, he really was elbowed. I don't know how intentional it was, but it really was.
What frustrates the Auburn head coach is it came after a review. So
yes,
not only was it possibly missed here, it was missed in Birmingham. Denver makes the second free throw. 9-point game. Got to get a stop, Auburn, 2:21 to go. Full length of the floor to go, Auburn presses. Inbound to Dillingham in the backcourt. Gets the ball to Shepherd. Shepherd races forward, gets it across midcourt. Hooks Chad Baker Mazzara. Bounce pass Reeves.
They won't shoot till late in the clock.
Left wing Dillingham. Shepherd at the top, 11 to shoot.
Inside
Kentucky
seven.
By 9. Now to Dillingham. Picked up by Broom on the outside. Inside the arc goes baseline, and he falls down and a foul on Jani Broom.
We had a good thing going right there until the foul occurred.
Now let's get another look at this one. Jani did not knock him down. That is a blown call. A blown call.
Did not touch him. Did not touch.
Dillingham, a 1 in bonus. Free throw. He missed it. Rebound Auburn. 1:53 to go. Down 9. Auburn ball. KD looks at the sideline. Now to Denver. 1:46 to go. Down 9. There's a screen from Broome. Denver drives to the hole. Hangs goes up and draws the foul. Stops the clock with 1:40 to go.
We're going
to
get two. There was a foul.
It's got to be two. I mean, they've been in the double bonus for a while. And Denver is at the line 4-2 for Auburn. Denver Jones with 10 points on the night. Could cut the lead to 7 right here with 1:40 to go. Free throw. Got it.
Got to knock them down. Got to have dead ball points. Got to get stops real quick.
Auburn 12 of 17 from the line in the second half. 20 of 29 on the night. Second free throw. Good.
All right. Got to have a stop. Got to press them.
66-59. Kentucky ball. Fierro in the backcourt. Shepherd races forward across midcourt. 1:34 and counting. It's a 7-point game. Got to get a stop, Auburn. Shepherd to Reeves. Reeves working on Broome. Janai has 4 fouls. Remember that. They'll switch off. They'll double team him. Dillingham drives it. Baseline. Fierro up, and he got fouled. Auburn had to foul him with 6 to shoot.
Yeah.
And he'll go to the line to shoot 2 for Kentucky.
Whoever Janai is guarding, he takes him away from the goal. They empty out the lane so they can try to get in there on the drive.
Fierro with 12 points on the night. His career high 16 came against Kansas back in November. He's had a nice night for Kentucky. First free throw rattles home.
I think he shot 70-some percent. He's a pretty good
free throw. 77% from the free throw line for Adu Fierro. Father played for Cal at Memphis, and he knocks home both.
We're going to have to foul some, but we're going to have to foul.
Yeah, and score at the other end. Denver Jones dribbles it. It comes to KD, and in and out of his hands and out of bounds. And Kentucky leads by 9 with 1:10 to go and has the basketball.
Yeah, we lost it out of
bounds. Yeah, Auburn just got a little rushed that time.
They will run somebody out if we defend the way we are. Right? They're calling timeout. What's this? Is this a timeout?
I think they're going to look at the clock. Are they going to review it to see that it went out of bounds indeed against KD Johnson?
I think that happened.
I do too, Sonny. Next up for this Auburn team, the Tigers are back on the road. Auburn gets Wednesday night off. And the Tigers play at Georgia next Saturday. That's a 5 o'clock Central Time start from Athens. Our pregame coverage starts at 4:30. Three in double figures tonight. Janai Broome, Chad Baker-Mazar, 14 apiece. Denver Jones with 12 for Auburn. 22 for Reeves. 14 for the Arrow. 11 for Dillingham. Auburn lost.
We're going to press.
Auburn lost Jalen Williams in the second half. A reminder, Kentucky did not have Trey Mitchell at all tonight. So
we have to make a decision on where we're going to foul.
Shepherd the inbound to Reeves. Gets it out of there to Wagner. And a near steal for KD. Wagner stays out of it. Gets it off the right side. Now to the top, Fierro. Under 1 minute to go. Kentucky by 9. 68-59. Drive. Wagner. Shepherd in the right corner. Throws it back to Wagner. 7 to shoot. Penetrates underneath. Head fake Reeves. Shepherd a 3 ball. He didn't get it. Rebound Chad Baker-Mazar. Down 9, Auburn ball. 37 seconds. Chad Baker-Mazar down the lane. He turned it over. Kentucky 2-on-1 the other way.
Kentucky
and Shepherd wisely will just take it out to the wing. Friends, that's going to do it. Kentucky's going to come to Auburn, snap the Tigers' 15-game home court winning streak. They will beat Auburn for the first time since 2019. Drive to the hole by Reeves. He put it up. He missed it. Rebound dunk by Unesu. And that'll do it for the Wildcats. 70-59, Kentucky, 10 seconds to go. Mazar across midcourt, right hand, ball tapped out of bounds by Kentucky with 6.1 seconds. Auburn never led tonight. It's the second straight Saturday in which the Tigers never had a lead in the ballgame.
I thought if we could keep them off the free throw line and we could get to the free throw line, we'd win this game. But none of those things have happened.
Timeout on the floor called by Auburn with 6.1 seconds to go. Kentucky safely on top of the Tigers, 70 to 59. Kentucky took the lead and never let up. Auburn had the lead down to 5 at one point in the second half. That's as close. Had the lead down to 5 and had the ball in the second half, but could get no closer. And this will be a tough one to swallow for Auburn, but you got to give credit for it to Kentucky to come in here and do what they did with this place absolutely charged for this one tonight.
Well, they have a good team.
Yes, they do, Sonny.
They have a deep team. They have a good bench. They can do a lot of things. They can score outside. I haven't seen big time scoring inside by them, but maybe they do have that.
Now, points in the paint. They outscored Auburn 36-26. Points off turnovers, 23-10, Sonny. They took that lead early and never relinquished it.
Yeah, that's right. And they defended awfully well. They defended without fouling. No foul trouble, I think, only one guy.
Auburn ball down the right sideline, 6.1 seconds to go. After an Auburn timeout, Chad Baker-Mazar, the inbound to KD Johnson at the top, to the right wing, Denver. Head fake, now steps back and pops a three. He missed it, and that's the way the game comes to a close and a fitting end to it. Auburn went 4 of 21 from the three-point stripe tonight, and the Tigers fall, make that 4 of 22, and the Tigers fall to Kentucky, 70-59. 14 points apiece for Jani Broom and Chad Baker-Mazara. They scored the most points for Auburn tonight. You can score points, too, with the Chick-fil-A app. Download or open the app to place an order, earn and redeem points with the Chick-fil-A app. War Eagle and eat more chicken. Stay tuned. The Regions Bank postgame show is next. Kentucky 70, Auburn 59.